and hurt my wrist on the table. But anyway, that's fine. soldier on. So we are going to be sharing with you guys. You know, this is, we just literally just turned this on for anyone who hasn't already heard about it. And you're like, oh my God, I can't believe I missed out on this. This is the very, very last chance to join live, you know, even though there will be a recording available.
There will be a recording, but live is much better. It's more personalized and you get to do the exercises as we go.
Yep. And we're going to be doing live, as Steve said, live exercises on the line. And you can ask, type through questions. We're going to get feedback in live time that we can answer in live time. So live is best.
Yes.
All right. So we're going to be starting out with sharing a bit of our story, and you know, just super quickly, but we're going to be referring back to our own life experiences throughout the workshop to use as examples where, you know, certain things have played out, like the masculine feminine energies, you know, and how that's kind of worked in with everything, how that's impacted us and led us to create what we've created now in this awesome relationship. Then we're going to go straight into talking about the feminine and masculine traits and energies, because it's so, so important to understand. Talking to two screens here.
I'm looking at you in that one and me in this one, and then I'm like, all...
That's why we're looking both, yeah. So we're going to be doing that. So jumping straight into, you know, it's so important to understand the masculine and feminine traits and energies, how they play out within our own lives, like individually within ourselves, and you know, just learning more about them, how we build up layers, all of that kind of thing. And then of course, you know, it's so important learning how they play out in relationships,
even leading into them, just bringing that awareness to yourself, leading into them, or if you're not in them, it's just having that awareness or learning that awareness, I think, of what they are,
to create more harmonious balance. All right, then we're going to do an exercise live on the line on really peeling back the layers, because, you know, when we're young and things happen, we start building up these layers of protection, the layers of different energy.
We're not going in too much in there because you guys there.
And then we're going to go into, give an example of, you know, when it's actually good to be in your feminine, when it's good to be in your masculine, right? Because it's not all about, you know, women need to be purely feminine and men need to be purely masculine.
It's a balance, like I say, a balance, yeah.
Harmonious balance, exactly. We're going to look at how each sex, masculine and feminine, deals with stress. And, you know, it's so important to understand so that you're not judging your partner and building up resentment towards them.
Yeah, and assuming and things like that. So that's actually a pretty cool part.
Yes, and Steve's going to be teaching a way that, you know, a lot of guys, they when they get stressed out, they go to their man cave. So
we've had some interesting conversations around this one.
They do some, you know, watch the news, do something to escape kind of the stress of their day. So Steve's going to be teaching an exercise that guys can do to release the stress from their day in a healthy way, so that they can be present for their for whatever's going on, their families, friends, partners, whatever. That's going to be really cool. And then halfway through, we're going to have a 2-minute break. Then we're going to look at the 6 human needs, and we're going to do a really cool exercise to make sure that. To look at, are you fulfilling your own human needs, right? Because if you're not only are you not going to be happy within yourself, but you're not going to be happy within
your relationship. If you're not aware of your own human needs and what you need to fulfill, how are you going to be aware of what your partner needs to get that balance too? It's so important.
Exactly. And to work together to make sure that it's both balanced, both of you are balanced within the relationship. Awesome. Then we're going to be teaching a really cool, the debrief.
You're
going to
let me talk? No, you're in the zone, but this is the thing here, yeah? Usually I would have led this, but I just felt she's done all the work here. I'll let her step up and do that. No, but we're going to teach them some really cool rituals. And it is, it's about finding the solution for all these things too, when problems arise and that. And that's going to be a cool exercise too, but it's something that the guys that are doing the training are going to be able to take and implement back in their own lives, which is really, really cool. Something we have both utilized with our own, what would you say, we've put our own spin on it a little bit to make it work with us. Well, we're going to be teaching that, and we're going to dive deep into that too.
And it's a debrief, so this is a really powerful ritual to do every evening. And the cool thing is that we've done this, we did this when we were single for many months before we even got together, and now we've adapted it for couples to be able to do.
But couples, and like I say, we go back to the point when we were even talking about this, is about what work we've done personally to get to the point where we can be in that relationship where we're aware of all these things.
So sometimes in the evening I just say, Steve, debrief me please, and then he makes a stupid joke about it.
Yeah, all the time. That's consistent anyway.
All right, next thing. What is this?
She's taken over again. Oh, what we're going to do then too, we're going to go into like your areas of life. Now, they are split up into several areas and they're so important. It's all about bringing awareness to where you're at, but more importantly, what you can do to get that balance in them areas. And then having that awareness again, it's very similar to the six human needs, bringing the awareness to your own life in them areas. And then when you're in a relationship or going into it, you're aware of what your partner might be, say, one of the things there is passions and enjoyment. That's one of the life areas. And it is. All this is about bringing awareness to, but what you can do to take steps to improve them areas.
And getting clear on what you actually do want, like life. Yeah. This is like life visioning, which is just, so important. So important. And then we're going to do...
That's pretty cool. I don't know if we want to share with these guys.
Well, this is just... this is what we get. It's just a description.
Yeah.
But we get... We're going to lock all of this in, it's going to be very interactive, high interaction, which we're really looking forward to with you guys on the workshop.
You guys
right
have got something
now.
Special coming at the end of this.
We're going to lock all this in at the end with a really, really awesome, powerful guided meditation, which is basically locking in.
It's locking in the goals, like in all areas, but relationships, if that's what we're going to highlight, locking in that, what you actually want, what is your vision of the relationship, the ideal relationship.
Locking it in on an unconscious level.
Exactly. Not just saying this is what I want. There's certain, like I say, it is guided there. There's certain things play out in that you do lock it in on a subconscious level, which is really, really important.
Very important. Very fun.
It is fun for us, but even more fun for you guys. It will. Like I say, it's very, very special. It's something that we really, really looked at as bringing to you guys to add that extra bit of, yeah, like I say, something special to the end of it so you can go forward and apply all this stuff.
Yeah. Awesome. All right. So we are going to get back to these beautiful people who are actually live on the workshop right now, right this very second. We're going to be talking a lot. So
yes, we are.
Really awesome. If any of you guys watching this right now or anyone you know perhaps wants to join and actually be on this live, all you need to do is click the link above, below, wherever it is. I think it's above.
You already put that in there.
I did.
Unreal. She's awesome.
So organized. Me being in my masculine. So all you need to do is click the link and you'll get instant access and come through to us live here. Cool. All right, guys. So much love.
Thank you. Bye bye. Back to you guys. Go. Done. How do we like? We just told you what it's all about. Not really.
So Ooh. Post.
Technology stuff going on post. Here.
Perfect. All right, we're good. Okay. Awesome. Okay, so Steve, would you like to begin with your story?
Right. Ooh, we've got excitement on here. Yeah, now a bit of my story. Now, when we were talking about this, and it was, like I say, with mine, and if we want to talk about relationships or even the relationship with myself, even thinking about this just before I started, I'm pretty sure I changed what I was going to say from last night, just to be spontaneous, but it's all relevant, I feel, in the way we're going to teach this whole workshop. It's really, really important that you can go back to areas in your life that you're aware of that may have been events where you didn't learn a lesson or you didn't take anything from it and move forward. But with these tools we're going to provide, these are the areas I'm able to go back to and say, well, this I can apply here to move forward. So, I can look at past relationships, but what I felt was important was my own journey of personal growth. Because that brought awareness to what I had to work on, and then I could work on that. Because at the core of it,
because it's about coming whole and complete within yourself.
It is, because I've always been of the belief, well, not always, for the last probably about 8 years, of the belief that I have to be the best version of myself to be
to be acceptable for someone
else. To be acceptable for someone else, or to be with anyone else and not look for that in a relationship to fill what I'm missing or something like that. I've always had that belief, but I never knew what to work on. I never knew how to to work on myself. I didn't up until probably it's pushing 2 years ago. And I did get into personal development. But leading up to that, some of the things that I couldn't do, I definitely couldn't sit this close to a beautiful woman like this. I couldn't. I'm still working on that part there. No. But I couldn't even approach anyone. I couldn't even on social media or anything. Like if I seen a girl I liked or anything like that, I couldn't approach him. Like I couldn't go out to dinner. But it even came into meeting new people. This was how bad it was, because I couldn't even meet new people and didn't like being in crowds, because I was so uncomfortable in my own skin. And I realized that to be able to, well, of course I wanted a relationship, of course I wanted to improve myself, I had to do some sort of work. And it just so happened that I did. I literally fell into personal development, if you will, because I was at an event where there was a lot of people, a lot of hot chicks as well. I don't know if you were there, were you there? I didn't notice, but because I was not attracted to her then. But no, this might keep rolling out too. But this to me, I can laugh and smile about this too. I was always afraid to talk about this. So you're going to get a little bit of gold here, I think. But at that time there,
we already got laughs coming through.
We're going to get laughs. Yeah, that's okay.
Have fun.
Yeah, it is to have fun. Yeah. And this was stuff that really, really affected me, like behind closed doors leading up to it. I went to an event, network marketing company, amazing people, heaps of women around, and I was scared of like being around all of them. I couldn't stand. I'm like, what do I do? And I got into personal development. And like I say, a lot of the tools that we're going to teach tonight are at the core of what I got into and I've consistently done for the last 20 months. Now, back to the problems I had. Not being able to talk to people or feeling comfortable in crowds. Or even when I go out to dinner, I'm pretty sure some of this will link into apparently I eat fast, but I go out to dinner. I didn't want to be seen there. And then I go, bang, 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 get out of there. I don't want to talk to anyone. Don't want to look anyone in the eye. So uncomfortable in my own skin. And even, I wasn't going to share this. I might now. I said that I was going to share something. I don't share this very, very often. She knows about it and she's been laughing at me ever since. But I got to the point, like when I was working away, I was like, no relationship, full stop. That's how bad I was. I don't want to talk to a woman. I don't want to see. I don't need this right now. I was that unhappy with myself. I'm like, I'm just going to work. So I didn't even, how can I put this? No interaction at all with females for 4 years. Not that I was counting. And that now I look back at that, that's like bloody extreme. It is, but that's how bad I was and how unhappy I was within myself, that I wouldn't put myself out there. There was no way in the world. And what I would do, even though this would really get to me, it was eating me up. I'm like, well, the supposed pain and fear of actually having to put myself through, or I'd have to go actually talk to someone. I'd have to actually maybe open up a little bit to them. I'm like, no way, there's too much pain there. I would rather lock myself away, stay at work, do whatever, and not have anything to do with it. But always knowing that one day I was going to have to do something. One day I was going to have to. I was sort of waiting for it to happen, but I knew that it wouldn't happen. I just had to maybe be in enough pain for what I was missing out to then make the changes. And it did. It came to that point, like I say, 20 months ago. I'm like, I've had enough.
Yeah.
It did. And that's what happens with a lot of us. And there was many moments where I'd either... Well, my very past before working away, that when I had drinking and alcohol problems and everything, a lot of that, and I'm sure you guys can relate, is I needed to feel comfortable. So I had to get drunk. I had to go out and take drugs and party to feel comfortable to even like sit this close or even to even approach someone. That's how it was. And it wasn't just females. That was people in general. And it shows the power of working on yourself too. It really does. Like I always look back and I'm like.
Now he doesn't shut up when he's out.
No, I don't, and I can't wait to go out. It's actually a strength of mine now, is being able to communicate with people and approach people and want to. That's gone from my absolute weakness to my absolute strength.
Yeah, and I think something. Can I just say something?
My story, but this is all right. I'll let her.
No, but something from this is about your story. So yeah. I think part of the reason that makes you like something I just understand is part of the reason that makes you so passionate about helping other people, but I think in particular men, is because you know like how that feels to feel so uncomfortable with yourself that you deprive yourself from relationships, you know, just connecting with people, which is what really enriches our lives and which is what makes our life so beautiful, is that the connections we have with people, the relationships we have with people. And that is, it's so, so sad, and it's not right, and it's so preventable, right?
It is preventable if you would. And like men, and you said, I touched on, I am passionate about showing men because of my own journey and story, especially like last year, for the whole 12 or 18 months, I was working with men directly, a lot of women too, but with men, and it's so common. And I'm like, well, yeah. I know from my own journey what I've been able to do. It's like preventable if you want to, but it's, I'm going to say fixable, but you can work away from that. And it's actually easier than being in the pain, suppressing everything and hiding away. That's a lot. And I did it for a long time. I did that ever since my teenage years. Yeah, I had relationships on the way. I might share a little bit on them later, just with some of the examples we give when we are teaching some of the energies in that. But for my own thing to suppress, to hide away from that, that was actually easier for me than stepping up and confronting up to what I had to work on. Yeah.
So, yeah. So it's very interesting that, you
four
know.
4 years.
4 years. When he told me that, I was like, oh, yes. But it's... It's really interesting, and I think this is something, you know, really cool, is that, you know, both of us had these issues within ourselves around, you know, not feeling comfortable within ourselves, with not wanting to open up to people, but we dealt with it in such different ways, because when it came to relationships, this is somewhere where we were very opposites in. So while Steve... No, but it's just different ways of coping, and, yeah. And it's a very perfect example of how we're all so different and we cope with things differently. So for me, I was actually like what I call a serial relationshiper. So like the first relationship that I was in, I got into when I was 15, and I was in that for 4.5 years. And this is an example of how the relationships you attract are purely a reflection of what's going on within you. So when I was 15 years old, that's when my mother passed away, and I had severely, severely low self-esteem. And so I attracted someone who treated me the way that I believed I deserved to be treated, really. And this is difficult for some people to grasp, because it's like, well, I don't believe I deserve to be beaten, or I don't believe I deserve to be treated badly. But it's what people don't understand. It's like, yeah, you know, consciously you're like, of course I don't want that. But on a deeper, deeper level, you know, there's parts within you that you're not actually aware of that does believe that you deserve that. Otherwise you would not have attracted that into your life. So that's what I attracted, and it was a very, really crazy relationship. But basically, after a couple of years, it turned into a physically abusive relationship, and my self-esteem was so low that I was terrified to leave, because I felt like this was the first person that had ever really loved me, and that if I left, that no one else would love me again, and I would just be alone again. Because that came from my childhood experience of my mother not being present and having an abusive father. So that was that. And then coming out of that relationship at 19 and a half, I did something different to Steve. So what I did is, from a very young age, I had this like wall of protection around me, because it was like, it was just me, myself, and I, me against the world, and I had to protect myself. And do you really want me to remember that?
You can if you want.
So I put up these layers and, you know, this wall of protection. And what that was is it was like, here was all of my pain and who I really was, like in here. And then here was like the wall. And then on the outside, it was like this crazy smiley girl, lots of, you know, bubbly, you know, easy to get along with people, and you know, just la 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 la, and you know, everyone loves me and guys love me and I'm so pretty and all of that, even though on the inside I was like terrified of actually opening up to someone and felt massive like self-rejection and massive not accepting myself, not feeling good enough, having low self-worth, all of that. And so I got into, you know, I just got into a whole lot of kind of relationship here, relationship there, whatever, but it was never anything that penetrated, could get through that wall of protection that I had around myself. Does that make sense?
Absolutely makes sense, yeah.
Yeah.
She's still like la-di-da-di-da, happy in that, but there's no, it's not a protection thing.
No.
It's her actually being happy within herself.
Yeah.
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 That's why she pulled it off so well. It's just, that's like how she is now. And it's a big thing, yeah.
Yeah, so that was how we kind of dealt with it. We dealt with it very differently. So just going to check feedback here.
Yeah. Yeah, well, that's obviously when I've been talking.
We are awesome creatures. Love it. Very much related. Yeah, awesome. And I think that's, you know, that, you know, you say you can relate. I think that's a lot of people like that, right? We close ourselves off. We put this facade on. But really, like, there's this wall protecting. And, you know, it's like we're almost terrified to show who we really are and what's really going on inside of us. Because I think for me, it was terrified. I was terrified that if I showed what was really going on and who I really was, that people wouldn't like me, that, you know, people would find me as disgusting as I found myself.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
And I think what we've touched on there, well, like, we've given a very, like, you can relate to that. I've given just little bits of what I know many men can relate to. And even the same with you, like, I've had friends in the past who've had the similar thing as you, that it's the other way. They do, they come across men, all like happy and all that, but men do it too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Players.
That's,
they got serious issues.
Seriously, seriously. And doing the work we've done, it is, when we talk about layers, there are layers. Like, it'd be awesome if you could just flick a switch and all this was gone and you're like happy, but there are layers, and the work we've done has been so important, and a lot of this has been uncovered on the way.
And people think it would be awesome if you could flick a switch, but actually you'd flick a switch and you'd be like, ah, what am I going to do now? This is boring. Life is supposed to be this journey. Yeah.
It is supposed to be. Get used to her correcting me too. Doing my best to speak properly.
Speak properly. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Awesome. Yeah.
I think what we're going to do through this, so, too, any questions and that, we're going to give question time after.
Yeah, we'll just way. Give, we'll just answer your questions kind of when we've finished giving a certain piece.
So we're content. Not ignoring you. Absolutely, fire some questions in there. That's what we want to make this as interactive for you guys as
but
possible.
But we also just want to cover all the content in these 3 hours. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
It wasn't so bad then. I was going to get vulnerable. Maybe I'm going to go deeper. Nah.
No, I think you know what it is. We're just sharing all this stuff so much. Like, you know, before I did this work for myself, I couldn't talk about my past and stuff without getting super emotional and feeling ashamed. And so it's just, we can share this now, and we're not tied to this massive emotion.
That we were.
That we carried.
Yeah. You
know, that was associated to that anymore. That makes sense. All right, so let us know if that made sense, all of that, although from your feedback, judging from your feedback, I think so. So we're going to start off with, as we said, we're going into the feminine, masculine traits.
Yes, yeah? So super, super important.
Yes, very important, because, like, what's happened in today's, like, today's society, like, even... You know, I think there's two things that has kind of had an impact on this, creating this out of whack balance for so many people with the masculine and feminine energy. Two things. You can give me an input. But one thing that I believe is the things that we go through when we're young, the traumas, the experiences, you know, significant events in our lives that we have a lot of emotion tied to, and how we react to that. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then the other thing is social conditioning. Yeah. So what I mean by that is saying, you know, women, we have to be these, like, strong, like, we're independent, you know, we don't need anyone. I can open my own car door, like.
Which women can, but it's.
We can.
On the deeper energy level, it's not. That's not the true feminine energy. It's
not. And it's when not. I, I was like that for so long because I was like, yeah, I'm strong, I don't need anyone. But really what was going on is that I was afraid to let my guard down and be feminine. Yeah. And once I did the healing, I was like, this is actually so nice to take a step back and let the man just take the lead sometimes, to let the man open the door for me and let the man say, you look beautiful. And yeah.
You do look beautiful, by the way.
Thank you. And yeah, and to let, you know, to, because I used to be control freak, like, this is how it's going to be and this is what we're going to do and this. And it was just part of me. It was just my fear around things.
It was. Just one more thing you said, the social conditioning, but also when we're talking about events when we're younger and that, even like the conditioning from growing up around our parents, the schoolyard, things like that too, that all interlinks.
Or social
conditioning. Yeah, social conditioning, and it interlinks like to events and that as well, how you react when you're younger as well. So, yeah.
Yes. All right. Do you want to start off with the feminine, masculine?
Yeah, I definitely want to start.
You can share the feminine.
I can share the feminine. Yes, I can. Because a lot of these traits I showed when I was suppressing and hiding away, believe it or not. A simple thing, and when we do an exercise after, we ask yourselves if you are, you believe what you are, masculine or feminine. So with the feminine, take note of these. Guys, definitely take notes.
Write this down.
This is super, super important. And you do refer to your own life and look and go, oh my God, or no, that's cool. I'm doing well here. This is all right. Mm-hmm. Some of the feminine ones, needs to feel safe. Yeah. Now, I'm sure you can relate to that. They want someone around, and it comes to, well, we can mention Tony Robbins. He did a room, a whole room of 1,000 people. That was a cool exercise where in the room he asks, how many women walked through a few weeks, and just to really go through this quick, have felt unsafe? Well, it was in the last 2 weeks. I think the last one was like 95% of the room.
Raise their hand.
So raise their hand.
Raise your hand if you're a woman and you felt unsafe in the last couple of weeks. 95% of the room, raise their hand.
Yep. And ask the men, and there was like 4. Now that's a huge stat, just from something in a massive room. That's it. But that is so, so common. But
it's something we don't think about. But it's,
don't think about it's until you ask.
Our biology. It's like within
us. Yeah. And that's all of this stuff comes from like the 2 million years of conditioning. It does. This is like our traits down to the core. It's in our DNA. This is not like something we've just gone out and talked to a few people and say, hey,
yeah.
This isn't.
Yeah.
Needs to experience love. And you'll notice that all these interlink. You can get into the hot thing all the way. But it's so true. And like I say, I'm sure you can relate on this. And when you don't feel love enough, this is where you start to make up in the other areas. You start to be in your masculine energy. If you're not feeling love all the time, and if you're lacking in that, and if you don't have someone around you who's masculine, or you are single, all these things can be out of balance.
You feel like you need to then step and, you know, take charge. Yeah.
Which is okay. Like we said at the start, there's no rights or wrongs here. Don't feel offended or like, oh no, this is so bad. I'm bad. This is just where you're at.
Yeah.
Bringing awareness to that. Values. Oh,
makes,
I don't want it.
Makes do you want that
one? No, you don't. This is an obvious one. Now, I'm going to use an example of me, and I just mentioned before about me being in my feminine energy. When a guy makes things really, really big and loses, like I used to get in a lot of fights and be very violent and make little things massive and carry on with it, that's actually a feminine trait or energy. It's great. If a woman does that, that's actually cool. Just be aware that you've got to stop sometimes, but it is okay. But it is. It's, Bex keeps raising her hand. That's all right. If that's you, that's cool. It makes sense. And for me, like I say, this is where I brought awareness to. I'm like, oh my goodness. I thought me defending myself and being loud and wanting to win the challenge or whatever it was, the argument, was a masculine. It was the absolute opposite. So as a feminine energy, that's actually a good thing.
So you can do an example of what, like me being overwhelming.
Overwhelm's a good one. Overwhelm's a good one, yeah. Because you got all these little things like bigger, 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 and it ends up in overwhelm. And that's when you get emotional.
So an example of this is, the other day we were sitting at the inside at the bench, and you know, I was like in the zone, like in the idea flowing zone, writing out some stuff, Steve comes over and he asked me a question. I don't even know what the question was. But I just stopped. And I was like, Steve, I'm in flow. Stop asking me questions when I'm in flow. You're ruining my flow. You've ruined it. That's it. I can't remember what I was writing anymore. It's just fuck. It's like, right? And I just like had this massive tantrum and Steve just like.
Oh, and that's a cool point for this. Like I say, as you take notes, as we go into this, it's about bringing awareness and being aware. This is where it is so important to know what these are. If you don't understand what these traits are, then how do you know? Like,
yeah. So instead of, right, if Steve didn't understand that, look, that's just me being a woman, then he could have been like, oh, why are you taking it so personally? Blah, blah, blah. And we could have butted heads, right, had conflict. But because he understood, he's like, wow, okay.
I was doing my best just to, like, not show me going, oh, I know what's going on here. But I did, I had an understanding, and it wasn't 100% understanding. Like, there's always something wrong there. Like, I know women, you can come up, and there might be something that is seriously wrong. But having that awareness that there will be a time when she comes down and we can maybe talk her through. She hasn't come down yet. Well, that look, nah. But they having that awareness, like, you can step away. Instead of having that clash or going on with them, say, what are you doing whatever.
He understands. He has a little laugh. And then,
yeah, I'm like, okay.
And then I'm like, oh. And then I understand, I realize that, like, oh, wow, I'm just blowing this way out of proportion.
Which is cool.
And then I'm like, then I can calm down. and we always end up laughing.
Yeah, we do. Values, love, and relationships, connections. Now, that is versus a masculine trait. We might as well use it here because it's in context. Like, we value achievements, completing things. We do. And sometimes that's where not having that understanding, there's that look again. You're gonna get used to that too. I can actually see it there without turning that way. That's where sometimes without that understanding, it can cause a bit of friction as well. It's like when you say you value love and relationships, which I do this is a good point too, having both energies. Sometimes I value love and relationships a lot too, and like, well, I do all the time, but it's one of them things, having that awareness that it is a feminine energy. Feminine is good in both.
Yeah.
It's very, very important.
And we'll go into this more when we give an example of how, each sex deals with stress differently.
Yeah.
And that we'll go into that further. But yeah, that's the point, is we will value love and relationships higher than achievement.
Yeah.
Which is what
you'll mention more on that in the masculine energy anyway. Stimulated by praise, because she set this up. She's done an amazing job. She has. I've done nothing. All day she's been working hard behind the scenes. But that's so true. It's like, and you've got to take notice. And like I say, it's bringing awareness to that. Having the awareness, that's really easy for a guy just to pay a few compliments here and there. That's easy. I think it is anyway.
And just that's just basic showing gratitude, you know. Yeah.
It is. Yeah. It is.
So you look beautiful. This is a really nice dinner,
Your
hair looks nice today, like,
yeah, you do need a haircut, but it'll look even better then.
Shh, don't tell them.
Right. I love this next one. Gathers and collects stuff.
His mum.
My mum, which is cool. That's okay. We understand that. But we've got something we're going to use a bit of an analogy after.
Yep.
Tell a bit of a story. Hunters versus gatherers, which is really, really cool. It's gonna open your eyes. I know. It just confirmed a few things for me. Yeah. But it's cool. Now, this one annoys the crap out of me, and it probably will with every man.
Remembers everything, and that's the same. We'll give an example of the meta report later.
Yes, we will. We will. And this has been coming up a lot since we've been preparing this workshop. We're like, that's you, because I keep forgetting stuff. It's like.
And I remember, like, this is what we were wearing, and this is what time it was.
Yeah, do you remember when I told you about this?
This is what earrings I was wearing.
Yeah, but that's...
And Steve's like, what?
But that's important, and that's some of the really key, like, feminine traits, or when they're in feminine that energy. Traits. Feminine traits.
So, to recap that, so needs to feel safe, needs to experience love, makes small things big, right? Because we're emotional, we're, like, it's beautiful, but... We can learn to harness it in sometimes. Values, love, and relationships above most else. stimulated by praise. Something important for guys to know.
You said that well.
Thank you. Gathers and collects stuff. We are gatherers by just, you know, by a 2 million year old conditioning, by our 2 million year old brain, and remembers everything, remembers the details of everything. We'll give an example of why soon.
Yeah.
All right. So masculine traits. So masculine. So as we said with the feminine, right, we put a very high value on having love and beautiful relationships, right? So men, in order to feel competent, right, or in other words, they, in terms of measuring their ego, they must achieve. They need to feel as if they're achieving things, which is why their brains are so wired to find solutions, right? And that's what's awesome about men, is like they're practical, they're logical, they find solutions for things, right? And so guys, if you're good at this, then that's awesome. You know that that's like dominant masculine energy. And of course, you know, we'll talk about this soon as well. Like it's, you know, when it's good to be masculine, it's good to be feminine, whether you're a man or a woman. Of course, there are times when you're a female that, yeah, especially if you're like an entrepreneur, or like a businesswoman or something like that, or your mum, that you need to be logical and practical and, you know, do things. But we'll go into more into that later. So needs to achieve in order to feel competent, okay, and puts a very high value on achieving and feeling competent. Men need freedom.
Yep.
The man cave. Hence the man cave. So they need their time and their space. They make things that are big small, right? So opposite of what we do.
Yep.
And this is something huge that can cause conflict in relationships, right? And you know, not even just in romantic relationships, any kind of relationships with a woman and a man. So, you know, the man, there's like this problem and the woman's like, oh my God, and she's freaking out about it. And, you know, can't think of an example.
I'll just give a basic example. Yeah. Not one that's happened to us. It's like you've left like something at home, like something little. Oh, I so yeah. need that. And the woman will be like, it might be like, being like, oh my God, if we don't get that, this person's going to freak out. This is going to go wrong and we've got to go back. We've got to do this and that. And the man's like, do you really need it? Is it that important? We'll just get there. It's not that important.
Yeah. And then the woman freaks out and she's like, why are you taking this seriously? Don't you care?
But that's how it is.
It's just our brains work differently.
And like what you said, that's where it can cause conflict. Because, yeah, you're saying it's like, well, you obviously don't care about what's important to me and all this sort of thing. Then questions come up.
Exactly. But look, ladies, if you really think about this, yes, you want a man to be sensitive to your needs, but one of the awesome, awesome things about men is how they are, when you're going, losing your shit, you're feeling overwhelmed, you're feeling crazy, he can be there calm and collected and calm you get down and really ground you. And that's something.
Use that same example from the other day. When you come in all overwhelmed and nuts, I'm like, oh, it's okay, not that bad. It's all right. It's the same thing. It's like to ground you. That's what it is. That's what we're here for.
So you can see it as a positive thing.
Yeah, it's a positive thing.
It's not them that they don't care about you. It's actually that they do care about you. Their brains just work differently.
Yeah, and we're looking for the solution. The solution is, well, we've got to get her calm. We know that she's going to calm down soon. We've just got to wait for that. Then problem will be solved.
Exactly.
Not that it was a problem in the first place, but...
wants to be appreciated. So, wow, your muscles look so good.
When she says it, but I know she's being sarcastic.
Yeah, so an example, what's something that
you... No, you tell me.
You'd like...
Look, I might have been lacking this a bit. I actually know that you appreciate me. How's that for awareness? Just by the way she is. Like, seriously. It's sometimes anyway, but... No, I actually just know because I can feel it. And I think that's an important thing. I like saying you don't have to say everything. It's your actions that sometimes show this. Which
actions speak louder than words.
They do. That's the cool part about it. And I've got no examples to give either.
So, yeah. So sometimes I will say something that, like, really how I will say something that to him that I do really appreciate him. You know, so for example, like,
I'm good at tennis.
I'm just on, but no, that I do really value how you always make me feel like everything's okay and you keep me grounded and you make me feel safe. And that's something that I really, really, I feel so deeply grateful for, because it's the first time in my life that I've been able to experience that, because it's, for me, it's something I didn't have in my childhood.
That's why she doesn't need to say it, because I'm just going to go, oh.
Yeah. So, of course, your actions are more important than your words, but of course, it's always good to, you know, sometimes we assume that people know things. It's always good to say it, you know. Share it verbally as well.
Yeah.
Cool. Wants to be appreciated. All right. Go away, test drive. Stimulated by challenge. So men love a challenge because it's an opportunity for them to show how competent they are.
Yeah, it is. You can see how these all interlink too.
Yeah, exactly. And men, so opposite to women, they forget things. Because, and we'll go into this later, but it's all to do with the 2 million-year-old brain once again, hunters and gatherers.
Yep.
They forget all the details because in their mind it's not important. It's just important about finding a solution, getting a result. So therefore, they don't need to remember these things like women do. So, okay, we're going to go more into this later. So to recap, masculine traits and energies are they need to feel, in order to feel competent, they need to achieve. They put a high value on achievement and competence. It's by men and their egos. they need freedom, right? They need their time and their space to de-stress and, you know, that's why the man cave is a thing. They make things that we think are very big, smaller. Okay, because they don't have all the crazy emotion tied to it. They need to be appreciated. Okay, they're stimulated by challenge, and they forget. We said forget everything here, yeah, but forget a lot of things. All right.
So what are we talking about?
Let's just. All right. So checking comments.
Yeah, very much relate. Looking and finding inner core is very. It is very,
very raw.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's a beautiful thing when you can start feeling safe enough and really opening that up, because that's when you discover who you really are and what you truly want in your life.
Yep.
So it can go, you have kind of need to wade through a bit of darkness and a bit of pain to get there, but it's so worth it. Fuck yes. Safe it is. It's true. I do that. That look. That look. The look.
That look, yes. That look.
No. All right.
Yeah, awesome. Like we say, take note of them. They're very important with some of the stuff we're going to be talking about here, but also to bring awareness to down the track. That's if you feel like you're losing touch of where you're going or your eye out of balance or anything like that, you can always refer back to just them simple traits and just where you add in them and what's going on in your life when you can refer to. So,
you can recognize like, oh, am I forgetting, you know, for a woman, oh, am I forgetting shit all the time? Well, that's you being in your masculine. Anyway, we're going to go, we'll use proper examples at it. All right, so we're about to do an exercise live with you guys online. First exercise of the workshop, on peeling back the layers. So before we do this, Steve will give you an understanding of what these layers are and why we build them up.
And it links into what we just talked about there then, where these traits actually come from as we're going up, and we used the examples earlier of stuff that happened when we're younger. It's not always when we're like little kids or anything, it's just when in the past. But we use for the example of this, say when you're younger, when something happens or an event or anything. It could be a loud noise when we're really, really young. You react a certain way. Now, when you're born, if you're a female and you're in feminine, you're going to go, most of the time, you're going to put up a layer which is masculine to protect yourself. What's that noise? What's that bang? Whatever it is. On a deeper level too, it can come from anywhere. It can come from arguing that. But just for the simple explanation of this, that first layer gets put up.
Can you draw it?
We want to show the layers. We can. It's just very simple.
Just
it is very, very simple.
You know, boom, something happens, you put up the message.
Yeah, I'll do it on this one. Even if you want to. I'm visual, so that makes sense for me to teach it that way. So, I'll just say there. When you start, like it can be before you're born, but like I said, I'm not going to go into detail. And as I'm talking about, just think about your own past or your own childhood or anything like that as something that this might spark. I'm like, do black, I'm going to change the colors. You just start. There's you there. We'll go for the purpose of this. You start in your feminine. Yeah.
So we're doing a woman, obviously. So yeah. You're born beautiful, feminine energy.
Yeah. Then what happens is something happens. Like I say, it might be a loud noise. It might be a fight between your parents or something. It could be anything like that. You don't know. You're just little and like pure and brand new. You're like blank. There's nothing there. You're just that little feminine energy. But something happens. Yeah. Yeah, what you do, you'll put up a masculine layer.
Yeah.
This is like right when we're brand new. Probably before we're cute, because some babies.
True, actually.
But it is, and it might be just a noise. You mightn't even remember this. We remember the significant events, and this is where this is really important to know. But after a while, you don't hear that noise, or there's no fights, or there's nothing bad around you. It doesn't have to be bad, but it just might be something similar. So over time, the next layer that goes up, you become more feminine again, because you're still feminine to your core, which is cool.
You let go, you relax, or just being
fit. But you've still got that little masculine reaction in there. That's key in this. It's the first way you reacted to something like that. And this is opposite for the men too. If you're masculine, these layers just swap around. You remember them traits too. Masculine, make things big, might start from one of these layers. What happens then is something similar happens, and it might be major, it might not be it. Just very similar to that event, that noise, that argument. You might be in an argument when you're growing up, whatever it is. And what happens then? You go another layer of masculine. You have protection. Oh, no. And your story is very relevant to this. It doesn't matter how you act, but it is a masculine layer. It's like, oh, no, lock myself in. That's it. Don't want anyone to see that felt so similar to that other time. Subconsciously, that's so similar. I've got to react the same way. I've got to protect myself more. I've got to put up a thicker layer. I don't want this to happen again.
Yeah, that's definitely me. So that was like, so probably I think the first thing that, probably the first time I put up a masculine layer would have been maybe when my parents divorced, which I was 1 years old, moved away from me. I was seeing my dad every day and then got put in daycare. Living in the city, and then so I probably put up that first layer right back then, and then the next, you know, there's all these little events, but the next significant event, okay, there's so many actually now that I'm going back, but probably would have been, it wouldn't have been an event, it probably would have been just realizing and experiencing that, you know, I didn't have a father there, and then also I had a mother who was very mentally unstable and wasn't present. And so immediately from my earliest memories, I didn't feel safe. I felt like it was just me and I needed to protect myself. This is from about four or five years old, my earliest memories. So already then I would have put up a very thick masculine layer.
Yeah.
Then probably the next biggest event was not long after that. That's when I started being abused by my father. And then it was a year or two after that he went to prison. Once again, my whole world was turned upside down. You know, my father was sent off to prison. I wasn't going to see him, you know, ever again. So I thought at that time. And at that time, my my mother had a complete breakdown, like psychosis, psychotic mental breakdown. That is when I put up, that was like, you know what? The world is against me. Yeah, I have no one. I'm completely alone. Very, very thick layer.
So when we're talking about peeling back the layers, that's what we're referring to, these. Like I say, yours goes on. It goes on later in life. I know when I done a lot of this work, and there's an exercise we're going to run through tonight, which is particular to this, but there are many things that I've done where it's gone to each of these layers or events. What I thought was stuff that happened in my 20s. I was very violent. I nearly went to jail like 3 times for getting in fights. And like I say, being very, very violent in my feminine, I found out down the track.
Making things crazy big.
Yeah, it was like that. It was like, I actually thought they were my problems. But when I started to do the work, it went back a lot further to when I was a kid. I heard a noise or there was a fight between my parents or someone around me. Boom, feminine loud. I'd cry or I'd scream or something like that. Next time, another loud. I'd get better, I'd be all right. I'd be like playing at school or kinder or everything. Back into my masculine energy. Things are great, life's great. I'm playing with my trucks in the sand. No dramas. Little fight at kinder or something. Similar to that first time. Well, I did. This is the thing. But that first, my subconscious, this reminds me of that. I'm going to react the same, but stronger. I'm going to go harder. I'm going to scream more. I'm going to throw my arms about it. I'm going to like do these things. I don't know how you fight as a little kid. But then cry and things like that. That went on. So my troubles in my 20s actually started from the way I reacted from the buildup of these layers. Like I say, these layers keep going. They keep going. Doesn't have to be major events, but it can be similar, just as long as there's some similarity. I'm not going to get into detail how we store these memories and stuff, but on a basic energetic level or how we react, these layers keep going. Just has to be slightly similar, and they keep going. They keep going all the way up to
and
now.
So this is also relevant. You know, this is not just within talking about masculine and feminine energy. It's also talking about when we have healing to do. When, you know, we have certain wounds that, you know, came from past experiences that we're still holding on to. And so it's all interlinked. When we start peeling back the layers, we peel them back by going in and healing these old wounds. And then kind of naturally, that's when we can start coming back to our core energy and being in balance. And once you've done a lot of work and a lot of healing, like we have done, you can actually learn how to balance out the masculine and feminine energy.
Yeah.
And what we'll talk about later is when it's actually good to be in your feminine and, you know, what are the good things about feminine and when it's good to be in masculine, right? And then what's really cool is when you can reach the point where you can balance those out. And say, right, like I need to turn on my masculine now, I need to get shit done.
Yeah.
Or right now, I actually have some healing to do. I need to be there for someone, be sensitive, and be feminine.
Yeah. And that's what all of this work is. And like I say, to peel back them layers, to work on them layers, to go through the healing, it does take work of continually going back to this. And like you said before, sometimes you've got to go back into the darkness to be able to unlock this and work on it, to peel back that layer, and then what comes out the other side, like, you improve. That's when you get breakthroughs.
Yeah. And people are afraid, you know, people are afraid to go back into their darkness because, you know, they're like, well, I don't want to feel upset. Or for me, I was afraid of experiencing the pain again. I felt like there was so much pain that I didn't know what was going to happen. Like, was I going to go crazy? Or, you know, because I had my mother, my father and my brother all had, you know, mental psychotic breakdown episodes and things. So I was actually afraid of that. But then as I started feeling more safe and doing more work, and I started getting to the core of it. So just type through a yes, guys. This will be a good time to do a Q&A.
Definitely.
Do you have any questions
at this
point? Throw
some questions on this, yes. Having and being with a partner that understands all this makes all the difference. It does, Bexter, and you are actually very, very privileged. Jeff has done a lot of work around this. And I've worked personally with him. It does. It makes,
that's why we're sharing this.
Yeah.
That's exactly why.
It is exactly why. throw some quick questions through. Like, we're going to have plenty of breaks through this to ask questions because we're covering a lot of ground. Like, we are.
Cool. All right. So, you're going to do the peeling back the layers exercise?
I am going to do the peeling back the layers exercise. And here's something else I'm going to throw in really, really quickly. See, I do random stuff like this.
What?
With this exercise we're going to do here, there's many different ways to do it. And the reason that we felt this was really important to do it after just showing, give you a basic understanding of these things can be linked to events. We want to take you back to at least one of these events. And the way we're going to guide you through this is to take you back there a few times. Sometimes you've got to go back to the dark events. The way we saw these memories too, and I know when I started this work, I found it really, really easy to go back to an event. It was like that because it was right here. It's meant to be a memory in the past. And through this, it's not about going back. You cannot change the event. Always know that you can never, ever change the event. The event's always there. What you can change is how...
Yes, the emotion.
The emotion.
Associated with it.
Exactly. What I spoke through her mouth then. But that's what you can do. And I used to... She channeled that through me. I didn't.
Yeah.
We're not meaning this either, by the way. This is how we are. It's serious. This, you know what? This is serious stuff too. Like, a lot of the work we've done has been really serious. Like, some of the stuff you've been sharing, it's really serious. And I know when we worked on it a lot, you couldn't talk about it so much because you had to take yourself there. But because you've done so much work on an emotional level with exercises like what we're going to run out here, she's able to talk about it freely now because...
Like the stuff from my past, yeah, like I would, yeah, I got to a point where like I would share it on maybe like a live feed or a video or something. But then I'd be like in this dark, like depressed place for like 2 or 3 days after or something and just be completely like total meltdown because it just affected me so much.
Yeah. A key thing, like I said, I'm just going to throw a little diagram in here really, really quickly. With this exercise too, when you repeat it, and it is something you can do basically yourself, but it's better to be guided. It's better to have someone...
But you can use the recording to do this.
You can use the... Absolutely. It's really important. But having someone there, like I say, with us, we had it with coaching and that being guided too, to take you back. Because when you're consciously aware of these events, you protect yourself. So it is better being guided by someone else. Like I say, the recording is going to be there. But this what happens when you take yourself back to an event and remember the layers, you go back and you work on the emotion. When you work on the emotion, just say, here's the event here. And you go back, here's the event. It's just that little circle there. Just don't worry about that. That there. You go back to that event. You got all these events that have happened in life. All these different events where you've reacted similar. All them little blue circle things are different events later in life. And you can even refer to them as layers too. When you work on the emotion and how you reacted and felt about the first event, you work on that. You don't have to work on all these events. Yeah, there's going to be a little bit of work, but when you work on the emotion and how you reacted around that and how you felt leaving that, what happens? You go back there and that changes. There's a cut there in the line. The emotion tied to these ones isn't as strong. They actually fall away.
Yeah, so what he's saying is that even though all of these events that happen have emotion tied to them, right, if you just start with working on this one and you release the emotion and, you know, tied to this one here, it means that automatically it'll kind of release the emotion tied to these ones also.
Yeah.
Because it changes the way your perception and your
association with the emotion and the feeling tied to it. Not saying they go away. And like I say, at the end of the day, this takes continual practice if you want to do that, of going back there. I just wanted to show that there. I thought of that before because I have done a lot of exercises, different exercises related into going back and peeling back the layers because that's what it's all about.
Yeah. All right.
So now the exercise. What I would suggest, we're going to put on some cool
music. I'm going to play some background music, and all you need to do is listen to Steve's voice. Now, I'm like the queen of guided meditations. I've been doing them for 4 years. And this is the key thing. This is healing you're about to do, okay? Whatever you want to call it, it's really healing. It's releasing negativity, everything that no longer serves you. And so to do this, you've got to allow yourself to be vulnerable, which means you need to feel safe. Because if you're feeling afraid, if you've got that guard up, then you're not going to open up and allow these parts, the wounds within you, or whatever it is within you, you're not going to allow those to be healed. And so, you know, when you're doing this, like right now, and when you listen to the recording as well, be in a safe place, like be somewhere you feel comfortable, you know, like in your bedroom where no one's going to interrupt you, put some candles on, have your crystals, flowers, whatever it is that makes you feel safe. It's so, so important to create that safe, comfortable, peaceful environment when you're doing this.
Yeah, this is very, very powerful. If you have that time where you have that space and you are safe, it's a very, very powerful exercise.
Really open up.
Yeah, and this is something, me personally, that I've been guided through a lot over the last 20 months. Took me a lot to get into because I wasn't feeling safe.
Yeah.
That was key.
That's a key point, is that maybe the first time that you hear this, you don't have a strong reaction to it and you're like, what is this? It's not working. Keep doing it. Like, keep listening to it, because it takes practice to be able to learn to start opening up. You may get it instantly, but a lot of us, we have these layers of protection.
No, we do. And like I say, and you got to put yourself through this now. So this I'll guide through this now. And if you got the music, before you close your eyes, write down. I really want you to really think. And like I said before, some of these events, even when we're little kids, we remember them. Not clearly, but write down a major event when you're younger. Just when you're younger. It could be like when I started, this was something in my 20s. Still in my 20s now. But it might be there. It might be there, because I'm going to guide you to go to this event. So write it down on the paper. Have a look at it for 15 or 20 seconds. Really, really take yourself there before you close your eyes. Have a look at it. Give us a significant event. And
that
we remember
a lot of emotion
tied to it, where you know it's really affected you and you still remember it clearly. Write that down. I'm going to wait till, just give us a thumbs up when you've written it down and you've had a few seconds to look at it and you're clear on it.
Cool. And just let us know that you can hear this background music.
All right, cool. I'm ready to go. So I want you to get comfortable. Close your eyes. I say get comfortable. You've had a look at that event. And just feel comfortable in yourself, whether you're laying down or you're sitting up in your chair. Just make sure, if you can, your feet are either touching the ground. I say you feel comfortable to go there. What I want you to do, it's just picture above your head, there's a line. We're going to call this your timeline. And it's going to go back to your past, this straight line. Just imagine yourself drawing that line back through the years, back towards this event. Quickly taking notice of where the line crosses on the way, but you're heading back to this event. I want you to follow that line. And I want you to take yourself there. This emotional event that you hold onto so tight with a lot of emotion. I want you to be in that event. I want you to really feel it. It's strong, it's there, it's happened. It really, really did affect how you felt. I want you to be in that for a second. Was it bright, loud? Take notice of just how you were, how it felt. Now what I want you to do, the emotion's strong there, I want you to step out of that picture. That's it, step out. And I want you to look from the outside looking in. Have a look. What is that picture? What does it look like? Is it bright still? Is there people everywhere? Is there lots of noise? Just make sure you feel it. But what I want you to do, looking in, for you to turn down the brightness. Dim it right down. That's it. Dim it down. Dim it down, dim it down. It's really dull. At the same time, sound. Make it quieter. That's it. Turn down the volume. That's it. Lower, lower. Turn it down. Down so you can't hear it at all. Now what I want you to do, I want you to step back into that picture. You can still feel it. The emotion's still there. I want you to feel it. And now what I want you to do, I want you to float up out of the picture. That's it, float up high. Float up high, like a bird looking down. Looking back at you in that picture. It's still bright. Still got the feeling there, it's still loud. What I want you to do from that bird's eye view, I want you to turn down the brightness. That's it, turn it down. Down lower, dim it down. Dim it down, that's it. At the same time, while you're looking in from the outside, I want you to turn down the volume. Turn down the volume. That's it, down lower. All that scatter, all that noise. Down lower. Down lower. Down so you can't hear it at all. From that bird's eye view now, I want you to float back over your timeline. That's it, follow it back. Just quickly take note of everything on the way. It's not important, it's there. Float all the way back. Back down into the room. Back down into the room. Back to now. And just for a moment, I just want you to sit there and just feel it. Back in the room, just lay there. Just go back to your breath. Just be in it for, just be in it there for a few seconds. Now what I want you to do, just open your eyes for a minute. You can sit up if you laid down. I'm going to say open your eyes. What I want you to do now, while we've got a second, just write a comment in the comments. How do you feel right now? This is really, really important.
What came up for you?
Yeah, what came up? It could be a word, it could be a feeling, it could be nothing. It could be nothing.
Whatever it is, it's perfect.
It is.
I have no judgment on it.
Whenever you're ready.
And let us know how the volume is as well. Not right now, but how it was during the meditation.
Loss. Yeah, that's cool. It doesn't mean anything to us either, by the way, guys. This is just a word for you, whatever came up. And you just got to know that that's whatever. That's there. Can mean a lot to you. Can mean nothing. That's whatever it is.
It's usually the emotion that tied to that is grief. So just for you, Bex, because you're on live now. If a loss and grief is something that you feel, the only way to get through grief is to allow yourself to grieve. Allow yourself to feel it and give yourself, like have the love and respect for yourself to actually give yourself the time and space to allow yourself to grieve. And that's all it is. Not having any negative perceptions, any guilt or anything else tied to it. But just pure grieving, because that's how you heal that. And eventually you come to acceptance.
All right. Cool. We're going to do that again. Do that again. So just take notice of where you are. If you're laying down again, lay down. Absolutely. I lay down to do this. But if you're sitting up there, just be comfortable in your chair. Have your feet on the ground, be grounded. Just notice your breath. Just take your time. There's no rush for this. Yeah, that's all good. However you're feeling now, Bex, that's perfect. It's perfect. Take your time too. Once you're settled there, noticing your breath, just close your eyes. Close your eyes. We're going to go back again. I want you to look up where that timeline is again. Just imagine that timeline. It's a short timeline. That's okay. It might be a really long one. You might have to go back a long way. Just notice it. Picture yourself floating back down that timeline, back to your past. Going back, still taking notice of everything along the way. Some new things might pop up. There might be a bit of brightness, a bit of noise. Might be just the same. It might be just dull and dim. Might have gone back a long way. And like I say, you might already be wherever you wanted to be. And you go back. Go back to that event again. That's if it is that event. So whatever you notice the most, wherever that emotion is coming from, go back. You float down back into that event. You really, really feel it, really hear it. What did it feel like? Put yourself in that event again. I say it might have changed. You might notice something different. It might be the same. The emotion might be stronger. Whatever it is, you really feel it. Now that you feel it, I want you to step out of it. Step out of it. If you're in a circle, if there's people there, just step away. You might be there by yourself, but step away and just picture yourself looking back at yourself from the outside. Now you're looking in from the outside. I want you to turn down the brightness. Really, really work hard to turn down that brightness. Turn it down, that's it, that's it. Turn it right down, turn it right down. Right down till it's all dim. It doesn't have to be dark, it just has to be a soft, soft, soft light. It's still there. Now what I want you to do, all that noise, all that loud noise that's coming from there, it might be clear, you might be hear people speak. It might be just noise, it might be music, whatever it is, I want you to turn that down. That's it. Like a switch. Just turn it down, lower, lower. It can be to silence, it can be just a soft, it might be just a murmur. So you've turned that down. I want you to notice, just take notice of what's changed. Now what I want you to do is float back, float up into the sky. That's it, float up high. So you're looking down. You got that bird's eye view, looking down. You can see yourself in there. Float around, just notice what's there. Notice the brightness, the sound. What I want you to do now, I want you to turn that sound down. Turn it down, turn it down, that's it. Turn it down really hard, turn it down. Turn it right down. Down low, that's it. Down low, and you can't hear anything at all. It's a peaceful quiet. Now you've turned the sound down. It's really low. That brightness, all that extra color, all that high emotion, it's bright. Yeah, it's tough to turn down. Turn it down now. Turn it down. Turn it down low. That's it. Dim it down. Dim it. Right down low. Right down low. Now is there not only no noise or little noise, there's little brightness. It's not so sharp. Now the brightness is down. The emotion is lower. There's no sound. It's softer. It's gentle. I want you to float back now. I want you to float back. That's it. Follow your timeline back. All the way back into the room. Come back down. Just notice yourself, notice your breath. Just take a moment. You can keep your eyes closed. Follow your breath. Whenever you're ready, we're going to turn the music down. Just be there for a minute. Be there for a minute. Open your eyes whenever you're ready. Take a moment. Whenever you feel whatever pops into your mind, if it's a word, if it's a sentence, if it's a feeling, if it's a color, just type in whatever it is that came up. Might be the same words. You might have went back to a different place.
It could have been the same event, but maybe the second time you had less emotion tied to it, which is cool. Or you may have had more emotion tied to it. Pain is big.
Pain. Oh.
Yeah. But that's perfect though, Vix, because if there's pain there and it's coming to the surface, because it needs to be healed. So that's perfect.
It is. Just out of curiosity, Beck, was this the same event?
Was it the same event that you felt lost?
And it's okay if it's not. Yes. No. And that's cool. And you know what? I think that's good. That's really good. Just know this is all good too. And it's awesome that you're taking yourself to that event.
And it's a good starting, seems like it's a starting point for you to do healing work on.
No, it's really cool. I'm gonna go one more time. I think this is like really important. I'm gonna go one more time.
And then we'll have a break.
And then we're gonna have a break after this, and it's really important. I'm gonna say we're gonna do one more time. Get comfortable again. I'm gonna say, even if you're watching the recording of this, feedback from this, write it down in a little book or what you're feeling. It's really, really important.
What came up for you?
What didn't come up? You're just like, well, I just feel weird. That's okay. Whatever it is just okay. There's no judgment on anyone, like even especially on yourself. That's the point of all this. So what I want to do now is get comfortable again. If you're laying down, lay down again. If you're sitting down, just sit down. Sit up straight. Just feel comfortable. If you felt pain or loss or anything, just let it be. Don't have to do anything about it. Just let it be. Just take a moment. Close your eyes.
Be friends with it.
Yeah. That's what this is about. This is not about changing it. It's not about reacting to it, fixing to it. It's just about noticing it. What do I want you to do now? You notice that timeline again. I'm going to do this a little bit differently too. Make sure you're comfortable. That timeline, before you float up over, I want you to notice that the timeline stretches out to your future also. So you've got your past, goes back down behind you. It also goes out to your future in front of you, way, way out to your future. It's really strong and bright. Whatever color it is, might be yellow, might be pink, might be white. Just take notice of it. Now it goes into your future. So as you notice it, I want you to float back up over onto your timeline. Go back to your past again. This time, as you're going through your past, I want you to notice on the way, there's a lot more brightness, there's a lot more happiness, there's a lot more sound. You're noticing things differently. You might have noticed these things earlier. You might not have. They might have changed a little bit. You might want to stop and have a look. You might just want to scoot on by. Just take me back to the event. Whatever it is, it's just right. Just know that all you have to do is notice. You go back over your timeline, all the way back to that event where there's the pain, where there's the loss. Where's all that emotion? But instead of stepping into it this time, I want you to notice from a bird's eye view from above. You don't have to go down there. It's changed. It's still pain. It's still loss. It's not as bright. It's not as much noise. The feeling has changed. It's still there. You still notice it. I just want you to float around there. Just notice. You're just floating there too. You feel light. You feel a little different. And just notice that whatever you are feeling, that's perfect. And notice that you have stepped away. Notice you are floating around. Notice it's just stored there. You can't change. Now I want you to float back down to the ground. You're still away, you're still observing. I just want you to walk around, have a look. Now what I want you to do, I want you to turn the sound right down again. Turn it down, that's it. It's softer, it's easier to turn down. It's not so bright anymore. It's not so bright, turn it down, step away. Just notice. As you step away, notice that everything's changed. As you step away, you're back over your timeline, you're floating back down, and instead of floating back down to the room, you're floating along your timeline out to the future. You're noticing a lot more on your way back. It's not harsh brightness, it's soft brightness. It's different, it's peaceful. There are sounds. You take notice, you just float back into the future. So much of your future has changed right now and you're just looking down. All I want you to do is notice. Notice what's different about your future, where you're heading. Now that you see things differently, now the new doors have opened, new energies. There's more color, there's more brightness, there's more happiness. It's more opportunity. You feel lighter. As you notice all this, just take a minute, remember the picture. Slowly, slowly, just come back down your timeline, back to the present, back to now. Back down into the room. That's it. Back down into the room, feel grounded again. Just notice your breath. Notice how peaceful you are, how much lighter. Whatever it is, just be there with yourself. Don't have to open your eyes. Take a few moments here. Laying down, stay laying down. If you're emotional, be emotional, it's good. You've got a smile on your face, smile. You feel nothing, that's okay. Everything right in this moment is just perfect. Everything is. Ooh. That was cool.
Yeah, very cool. And one really cool thing about you, Beast, is how it's really awesome how you've instantly been able to just be completely open and vulnerable.
That helps a lot in this, yeah.
Yeah, it just means that, you know, it's perfect because it means, or it just shows that this whole process is going to happen a lot faster and a lot easier, more easily for you because you're open to it. You know, it's only when people put that protection up and they have that resistance that it makes it more difficult. Cool.
Whenever you're ready, just write down if you want to share it, how you're feeling now, if you're confused, if you're frustrated, whatever it is, share now. You don't have to share. If you've got any questions, anything came up, anything that changed, then now's a great time just to write it down, because whatever comes up now is really important.
Cool. So yeah, and then we're gonna have a break. So
then we will have a break, and we'll actually finally grieve. Cool.
Awesome. That's awesome. Awesome. Awesome.
It is
really, really cool. Yay! And yeah, you're gonna have this recording, so you can literally use this. And you know what I did is you can actually record the segment of the guided meditation on your phone, just to have there, so you can use it like whenever you need. You can do the stuff like whenever you feel you need it. And actually, I'll grieve my dad. Yeah, perfect. That's really cool.
It is good. It's really good. And what you find by, like I say, going back over this and over this again, you don't have to go to the same event. Other stuff's going to come up. Like I say, you are going to notice other stuff come up, and it could be further back. It could be something.
It could be stuff you weren't even aware of that you were still holding on to. Mm.
And I always use the example of me. The stuff that I worked on, I thought it was my 20s and my teenage years. By the time I worked on this and I did a lot of this sort of exercise, it was stuff when I was really, really young. And a lot of it wasn't so major. But it because of the layers and how I reacted and how I closed off over time, it was major in the end. So, no, well done through that. That was awesome. Really, really cool.
Yay. All right, so if you guys, you're welcome to still type through any questions or anything, but we're already at the halfway point.
Which is super cool.
Perfect, yeah, some perfect timing.
Absolutely spot on.
So we're gonna have a 5 to 10 minute break. Now, if you're on live now, or even if you're in the, you know, doing the recording of this, highly recommend, you've just done something that's really powerful and really opened you up. You've just been working on your unconscious mind. So really important to just stay calm and stay relaxed. Like, don't talk to anyone. Don't go on Facebook. Don't watch TV. Don't do anything. Just stay
just
in
stay
your
and
calm.
Be. It's really, really, it's really, really important. Even after this whole workshop. Have some time with you.
Chill time.
Chill time. Like I say, definitely no TV or Facebook. No explaining how you feel to everyone, all this sort of stuff. Just be with you. This is the important part about this, remember.
Unless you want to say how awesome the workshop was.
Yeah, well, you can talk to us. No, but it is important. This stuff is getting past you and what you're consciously aware of.
Just allow it to settle. And
Yeah. What do we got there? We'll answer questions. I lost him when I was 10, and then I lost him 12 months ago by death and not by choice. Yeah, cool. No, thank you, Baxter, like I say, for being open with all of this stuff and trusting us and trusting the process. I think that's a big thing with this. And just know that you by being vulnerable and being so trustful with that. Is that a word? I think it is.
Trusting.
Well, I have to ask now. But that you're actually going to work on this really, really fast. The more open and vulnerable you are,
the faster this will happen.
Yeah. Abandonment issues.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this is going to bring up some stuff. And it is. It's tough stuff. Yeah. It is. But
it's the thing. This is a thing to remember and know is that people may be afraid to go back to these dark places, but always remember that you've already been through it and you're still alive. Right. So by going back there, you're not going to die, right? You're not going to go crazy. You're stronger than you think. And by going through this, you're going to come out and live an awesome, awesome life. You're going to feel lighter. You're going to feel freer or free and everything that Steve described. Looking over your future and the timeline.
Yeah.
By doing this. Yes, I am strong. You are. And you know what? Going into...
And happy. Even better. There you go.
And happy. Yeah,
it's
exactly.
A good combination.
And you know, like stuff I teach, I go more into, you know, I integrate a lot of spirituality in my coaching. And you know, something I really truly believe is that we are only dealt lessons in life that we can deal with. Or in other words, we're only dealt the lessons in life that we're strong enough to deal with. So whatever happens in your life, even if it makes you feel like you cannot go on anymore, like you've been completely crushed by everything that's happened in your life, you do have that strength within you. Otherwise, you would not have been dealt those lessons in your life. You would not have been given those experiences.
Yeah. Just know that. That's really, really important to know that, because I think a lot of us hold on to stuff for too long because we forget that, or we don't know that we are strong enough to get through that. We don't believe it, and we lose belief in ourselves. That's why we get stuck there.
Yeah. Cool. So I'll touch on that 5 minutes when we come back, but we're going to have a break now, just doing our best to stick to time here.
Yep.
So 5 to 10 minute break, have a drink, go to the bathroom, but remember, chill time. I'll see you guys soon. We'll keep this running.
Yeah.
I'll just talk about that for 5 minutes when we come back.
Yeah, cool. It's important.
Spiritual contracts. Just 5 minutes because it's relevant.
Yeah, all relevant.
Stretch my legs. I did a worse laugh when you said scoot on by. What can I use? I'm going to give an example of a meta report.
Still recording.
Yeah. I was thinking about something before and I forgot.
It's like, wouldn't you comment if you get stuff?
That's so funny. I dropped the.
Can't believe the phone rang through there from that random.
share that into the group?
I'm sharing on my what's name page.
Public Finger Connection.
Is that you just did that on Facebook, yeah? Yeah. I'm just share it to my Facebook page.
Sharing it to your eye.
Making me hungry, I am.
Oh. It's in the washing basket.
You know, that was cool. As soon as I started that, everything came back to me. Yeah. Like, that was, I'm like, cool.
Yeah. It's been hiding.
Yeah. The layers.
Was it even feminine remembering stuff?
Maybe that's why I forgot it all.
Same mess, yeah. Alright. Let's do this. Hour and a half to
90 minutes down, and you bring out food.
Just some crackers. Got to keep the blood.
Hey, Bex, we're back.
Hey, we're back.
We're back. I've been busy.
Part two.
Busy working and everything, and she goes and gets food.
Hey, I shared the video into the group, okay?
I was doing my best. I was not hungry. I was not hungry because I had a shake and some of them frozen boost things, which are amazing before. I'm like, I'm not going to need food. And she knows how easy it is for me to get hungry. I'm going to test you through this second 90 minutes.
That I ate for lunch that you stole.
How you feeling there, Bex? That was some pretty powerful stuff there.
It's really deep stuff, so maybe, but it's normal, just like in our own experience, by being the person doing the guided meditation.
Really good, actually.
Yeah, awesome. Cool. Like, I know that, like, I remember, like, when Steve was coaching me and we were doing this, he was running this course, there were a few of us on there, and he did, like, a few of these guided meditations back to back.
That's cool.
Awesome, Bex. That's so cool.
Yeah, that is as good.
Appreciated. He's appreciated. Feels appreciated.
We can finish this now. Job done.
Result. No, but I remember, like, so we did these kind of meditations, and the next day, and just telling you this because it's really relevant, you know, for what might come up. Remember the next day, everyone was messaging Steve going, feel a bit weird. Like, what's going on? And, like, it's kind of crazy. Like, you can almost feel like energy shifts within you, right? Because your emotions are stored within your physical body, but also within your energetic body. And so, like, yeah, it shifts. And
yeah, it does. And like, yeah, I say all through this, just notice. And the more vulnerable you are, the more change you're going to notice.
Yeah, and faster.
It is. The faster this can all evolve.
So, all right. So we're into the second half, guys. And we are going to start off with,
we've rolled out a lot there, especially if you guys are jumping on the recording. Always know we've rolled out a lot of content in that first half. Go back through it. Definitely check your notes. Take more notes. Yeah, listen to the meditation.
Yeah, courses that I've done, I've listened to them like over like so many times because you can't. It's almost as if you can't absorb everything within the first time you listen.
Yeah.
So, yeah, just listen to it
a few times. And we've structured this a certain way too. Just know that this isn't just slapped together. All this is structured with the meditations, with everything we've put in here. Some of the stories are random, but everything else is structured.
The humor's random.
it is, yeah. It's not put on, but it's random.
So we're going to kick off with just talking a little bit about when it's actually good to be, you know, because all of us, men and women, we want to have balance. So obviously a woman predominantly, we want to be in our feminine, okay? And a man predominantly wants to be in his masculine. However, we want to have a balance of the two within us. That's like what yin and yang is all about, light and dark, right? It's just the balance of the masculine, feminine energy within every being. And there's different times to tap into both of those. So, all right. So, what is good about the feminine?
Ooh.
Feminine energy. So, to start off with, it's good to be in your feminine energy. So, this is for men and women. When it comes to, like, what you guys are doing now, when it comes to being vulnerable and healing, Okay. So did Bix. So Bix, did you say?
She's like a sponge right now. That's good.
Oh, awesome.
Layers. Cool. Layers.
The layers are peeling back.
It's good.
So, what was I saying? Ah, oh, yes. So it's good to be in your feminine when you are, when you're healing, when you're wanting to open up, be vulnerable, shed layers, release things that are no longer serving you. That's when it's good to be feminine and feminine energy, because that's what feminine is beautiful about. Feminine energy is that by nature we're so open, we're willing to be vulnerable, we don't have a guard up. And that's something that is really beautiful about feminine. So yeah. For men, it's really nice when, you know, once a man understands all of this, they can tap into that feminine energy when they need to. So an example of this would be if a woman comes to their partner and she's upset, she's emotional, right? And she wants the man to not be a man and go, well, what, you know, what's the solution to this? And start giving you advice and trying to fix you. What you want is just someone to be there for you and listen and be present. And so that's when a man can tap into his feminine energy and just be compassionate, be present, and just listen. I'm doing my best here not to go into everything else we're going
to
go into.
There's a lot to go into, but that's, yeah. I think that's a lot of this leads to like the present, being present with anyone. It is so important. And we've touched on the traits with the men. Being present can be tough sometimes because their mind is on completing a task or something else. There's a problem to fix or anything. And that's something to tap into that feminine energy, to be more present. To
be sensitive,
yeah, and not block out everything else, but just like I say, bring it back to and pay close attention to what is going on there. And that's powerful, the powerful power of being present.
And then also with feminine energy, it's something that is really cool about us ladies and the feminine energy is the ability. You know, sometimes we see this as a negative thing, but it's our ability to go, have our emotions go like this, right? We move through our emotions with such ease just by nature. And, you know, sometimes we see it as, oh, you know, you get overwhelmed or you're an emotional person. But the awesome, awesome thing about this is it means that when we're truly in our feminine, we're not getting stuck in things, right? So, for example, you know, like what you said, Bex, something big happens, like you lost your dad, right? Like me, I lost my mom as well. So when we can just truly be feminine and allow ourselves to go into that emotion, feel it, it's awesome because we can move through it really quickly. We don't get stuck, okay? Versus if you're like men, that's when they can get really, like they just suppress it.
Yeah, and we'll go into a couple of things, what we do there, the whole man cave thing, but we suppress it. If we cannot find a solution for it, we'll suppress it. We'll move something else on to something else to solve.
Yeah.
Instead of knowing and being, like say, in feminine energy, letting it flow.
Just flowing with the emotion.
Yeah, with the emotion.
Feel it, allowing yourself to be vulnerable.
Yeah, something like that is a very clear difference between the masculine and feminine, how we deal with it too, with, like I say, which is what we're leading into, which is very important to understand.
Super important. And then obviously, you know, with a good time to be in your masculine is when you do actually need to be practical. Like, you know, you need to make stuff happen. Shit needs to get done, right? That is when it's awesome to be in your masculine energy because you're practical. You're not all over the show getting like overwhelmed or anything. You're just honing in on one thing, finding a solution to it and being efficient.
Yeah.
And Steve has witnessed me. And I'm very good at getting into that zone.
Yeah, but it's a good thing. And especially lately, it's something that she's had to tap back into because she's done so much work to be more feminine, to understand the feminine more. When it came to she come back into balance because she went so far down that way that she needed to start like, all right, I've got to do this. I've got to get back in my masculine. You've got to start getting shit done.
Yeah. So it was just about me, exactly. So it's a perfect example of how we need to actually find the balance, because I was in my masculine for so many years, right? Just, you know, I'm independent, I'm 91, I'm tough, I'm strong. And then finally, like, letting go, letting down those walls and just allowing myself to be me and be vulnerable and open up and let someone take care of me. And also really got into my spirituality and all of that. So what happened was I got too far. I was completely feminine, like too far down that track. I was out of balance. Okay, so it was awesome because it was like, yeah, I'm in my feminine energy now and it was a beautiful thing. But what happened was that I got out of balance. So just hope there are a yes if this is making sense. So the way for me to start getting back into balance was to recognize, like, okay, you know what? You know, I need to do my money tracking now. Or, you know, I need to reach out, message these people, reply to these people. Otherwise, things are not going to happen, right? In order to create this workshop, I needed to be in my masculine energy at times to do the practical things, make things happen.
I think a cool thing, if you want to put a little bit of a relationship spin on it, like from being in that relationship, when you're both aware of this, I think that helps too. And it's not from like, well, I know you've got to do this or anything. It's like being aware.
Like last night is a good example of...
We've got lots of examples of this. This is why we wanted to really, really wanted to teach you this, guys, because since we have come closer in the relationship through all the work we've done and become aware of so many things, once we're in here, all these things come up and we're like, oh, that's that. Oh, yeah, wow.
So we're able to be so much more understanding of each other. So,
yeah.
So, for example, last night, you know, we were putting together all the content, working out the details, what order we're going to put it in, what we're going to share. And so I was like on my laptop, like super like, come on, be efficient.
Do it like this. We're just going to do it this way. We're going to do this way. I had a relevant point. I was getting frustrated. But she's like, no, we'll just do this now. We'll worry about that tomorrow. We'll just go boom, 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 boom. Massively in a masculine, but we needed to get this done. Like, we put a lot of prep into it, but last night was really important because the day dragged out and we probably left it a little bit late. And well, we were tired and that, but she was in that zone. And I actually had to pull myself up. I'm like, oh, this is going to be so much better. This is me internally. And I did voice it at one stage. But when it got to that point, when I pulled back a little bit and let her be, I'm like, and I even was a bit cheeky. I think I said something like, no, that's okay. This is your thing or whatever. That's playing into the masculine energy. I don't know if she was aware of that. And she's like, yes, I'm going to get this done. I'm right.
But Steve was able, what happened is that you were actually able to back down a bit.
Yeah.
Because like what happens is if Steve didn't understand this, we would end up butting heads because he would get into his masculine. Be like, well, this is the way.
Well, I was.
I want to do it my way.
Don't get me wrong. It wasn't like, oh, this is okay. I was like, oh, damn, this is going to be so much better. But
damn it, woman.
Yeah, I'm like, oh. But having that awareness, I'm like, I was just, all I had to do was pick the point where I was like, no, you're not, it's not a battle here. It's not, I know, I cannot go like that because then there will be no solution. So my actual true core masculine energy to get the solution wasn't going to happen. So I had to like, all right, wait a sec. I'll go with this and there's still a way to get a solution here. And how did it end up?
Yeah.
I was probably a bit cheeky at the end, but it ended up the way I wanted it anyway, but the way we both wanted it.
Yeah. We came to a compromise.
Yeah. Which is cool. There was like a few of them at play there. And
because it was me to also recognize that, like, okay, I'm being like super bossy and dominant here.
Yeah.
And so it was both of us coming to balancing out and coming to a compromise.
And then at the end, she's like, all cuddly. And so like,
and then I was like, I'm so excited.
Yeah.
Being all, yeah, going straight back to. Yeah. So, all right, just check the comments.
Check comments. Yeah, absolutely. And it's all about honesty. That's what all this is about. And I think when we're talking about doing the workshop, to be able to share just a little bit more, we're always honest and open, but there's always a lot more we can share. Like, we can add a lot of value, but to add value to you guys who commit to something like this, who we know you just want to do the work, that I think being absolutely open and sharing as much as we can especially little stories. There's so many examples of this that's crazy. And you know what?
Us opening up and being vulnerable gives you permission unconsciously to be more vulnerable.
Exactly.
All right. So, Mr. Stevo. Stevo.
Mr. Me. Did you want to talk about these or not?
I feel like let's keep on going with this.
Well, that is the right end
because it's quite out of the topic.
Yep.
All right. Honesty is where's the comic gone? Honesty is what Jeff and I have, and that is everything. Absolutely. Trust. Knowing that you can trust and rely on your partner is everything.
Always remember too, and this is why we're big believers in and what we've actually lived, is it always comes back to you. Be honest with yourself.
Yeah.
That's key in this. Don't feel that your partner has to be honest with you first for you to open up and be honest or trust and all that. Always start with you. I think that's what this is all about.
Be honest in what it is you truly want. Be honest about what you're telling yourself. Be honest. Yeah, awesome. All right, so, Steve-o.
That's me.
Good, my Australian's coming along well, my Australian.
Let's not turn it into one of these. This is an ongoing battle. This is where I'm not going to open up about and be vulnerable and let you in on how much. Nah.
All right. So, Stephen, would you like to share some things that men can start doing to start stepping back into their masculine, beautiful masculine energy, the dominant, strong leader energy, and allowing, which then allows the women to be more feminine, to relax a bit more. So we're going to go over what men can do.
Just simple stuff. Before I get into this too, thank you for that. She's doing well. You're doing really, really well. You could probably do the whole thing. She's making me feel better by how good a job she's doing. But anyway. But before we go in this, just know too that you can be single to know all these things. You can be in a relationship and it's not about, oh, I know all this now, I'm going to go tell my partner. Just you can lead this by you simply knowing certain things you can do a little bit differently. Your actions are actually going to lead them to do something a little bit differently.
Yeah.
Never get
that
confused.
It'll bring out a different response in them.
Yeah. It's awesome if you can both learn this. It's awesome. But a lot of the time you're like, I know all this now. I'm going to change it. I'm going to tell my partner I've got to do this.
Don't go verbal diarrhea on your partner. Like, you've got to do this and this and this and this.
No, it will not. That'll backfire. It's as simple as that.
You just start applying what you've learned from this in the relationship and see what happens.
Exactly.
And if your partner's open to it, get them to watch
the
training.
That's the key. If they're open, if they notice different and they ask questions like, wow, this is different. Why are you being so different? All this, and it will be. And it's like doing this stuff over. And this is just really, really simple stuff. Like, you may have noticed I might pay Tanya here a few compliments. That's
praise.
Praise is massive, like continual. I know a lot of...
Make it authentic.
It's authentic, of course it is.
Like if you're, you know, your partner's hair is like, she's just gone out of bed and it looks like fucking
crazy.
It's like
Princess Leia. See? She was hot.
And it's all crazy, right? And you're like... It's pretty obvious that the hair looks like shit. Don't be like, oh my God, honey, your hair looks so beautiful today. Obviously, right? Because then she's just going to be like, what the fuck are you talking about? Like, make it genuine, make it authentic, but just start being more conscious of times when it's like, wow, you know, you look beautiful today. Or
I think the key comes back to being present in that moment too. And when you're more present, you notice more.
Yeah.
You notice more the little things, but you've got to voice that. I don't think it happens enough. A lot of the time, I think, and this is just my opinion, men don't do it enough because they feel they need something in return, or they feel their partner might think they're sucking up or anything like that. That's my opinion in the past, and that's why they don't do it a lot. But simple compliments, simple praise.
Makes all the difference. Simple, authentic praise.
Yeah. Actually, I've got this is something that just come up. Remember when we were sitting there, and I'll give context to this here where I probably got it wrong and didn't pay her praise when you cooked that meal and you put a lot of work into it. Instead of me praising her for doing such a good job, I started playing around with the food a little bit. When I didn't pay her praise, it sort of backfired a little bit. when she was just feeling she deserved praise. That's females are always wanting that praise. It's
also, I've just cooked this food for you.
Yeah.
And then you made a joke and did something playful with it, which was not funny at all.
And I must say, like, a great thing I love about you, you're open and honest with stuff straight away. A lot of women, she may have held on to that, and I might not have known at that point. I should just praise her and said, amazing job. But she's straight out with it, and she's like, hey, whatever she called me. And I was like, oh, that's an extreme example, but only because you're so honest and open that I knew straight away that I was out of line. It's not a, yeah, but praise, simple thing. Like I said, that was an extreme example, but
yeah,
like it just come to me then. I'm like, ooh.
So.
Yes, but anyway, I'll roll through these. Praise, simple things, and I've done this all the time. I don't know how long it took you to notice how many doors I opened for you and how I always rush to be first to the door.
I would hold my handbag.
I hold her handbag sometimes. Just doing them simple things, like, and I'll tell another one.
For example, like the other day we went for a swim and turned out to be a really rainy, cold day, like 26 degrees. That's cold up here where we live. And then we got in the car and he turned the heater on and I didn't even need to put the air vents like so that the heat going on me. He like just put them on me to make sure that I'm warm. Like things like that, that's the whole action speak louder than words thing. And that's how it's all these things that he does for me that makes me know how much, I know how much he loves me. And, you know, before he ever even said it to me, I already knew that by the way that he was with me.
Yeah. And it's just having awareness of this sort of stuff. It is. It's just like, and it's not anything that's out of my way. It actually makes me feel good. It's like, because she appreciates it.
Yeah.
See like, what happens there?
That's so sweet.
So that's not only am I.
Yeah. So what exactly? So what backfires nowadays in relationships is for women, we have this social conditioning of like, you know, be a tough woman, be independent, we don't need anything, that bullshit. You know, like, of course it's great in one aspect, but that's not what we're talking about here. Where this bucks up in a relationship is where, for example, you know, your partner does something nice for you. So say Steve did that for me, or he opened the car door for me, and I say, I don't need you to open the car door for me. Or I can do that myself. I don't need you to do that for me. You know, like, and then the man's like, well, what? Whoa. Like, I'm just trying to show her that I love her and I care about her and I want to take care of her. And she's like, not only is she not appreciating it, she's like totally like rejecting it. And then resentment kicks in it because it's so out of balance. It's not the way it's supposed to be.
Yeah, like, that's my relationships in the past, massively. Simple things like that I was always pushing. And this is before I learned all this, but I just had that feeling that that's what I had to do. But I'd do that. I'd get, like, verbally abused. Like, I can handle this myself. I can do that myself. Boy, you don't have to do that. No, get out of my way.
It's like we know. You don't need to prove, ladies, you don't need to prove anything. Of course you can open your own car door. Of course you can put the heater on like yourself. It's not about that. It's about your partner wants to take care of you. And like, this is ingrained within us, like since the beginning of time, that men want to take care of you to make you happy. And women at your core, whether you realize it or not, you want to be taken care of. So don't mess with that.
Don't. And at the end of the day, like I say, you're balancing up the two energies. One of the key things we mentioned earlier, men want to be appreciated. And if it's simple little things.
So next time, if you've noticed that you've been like that in the past, next time your partner does something nice for you, show appreciation for it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And that leads to a lot more, like I say.
Yeah. I mean, it's something that we could talk, we can give so many examples and talk so much about. But
yeah, this is a good one. Like, organize things or like take control of situations. A good thing that I actually just thought of then too is, and this was something I actually coached someone on last year, was even when you're out and about walking, I don't know if you notice, I always want to go in front. I want to be the one going in front. When the woman leads the man, so take notice of this, guys. Just think about it. If you're in a relationship now or you've been in the past, if the woman's always out in front doing this, organize this, same sort of thing you're touching on then.
That's the woman being in her masculine.
That's masculine energy. And then,
out of balance.
Yeah, out of balance. And the man actually feels like he's less significant. And he's like, well I'm just going to follow behind. It actually makes him fall back into it.
So into his
feminine. Into his feminine. All the other things that lead on from that, well, she can handle that. She can handle that. That's actually leading her to be in her masculine more without him even knowing it.
Yeah. So, yeah. And I notice this all the time. Like, because I'm so aware of this, I notice it all the time. So another example of this is, you know, if I'm in a restaurant and I'll see this, like it's so common nowadays that, you know, there's a family sitting there, you know, husband, wife, and couple of children. And, you know, the waitress comes over to take an order and the woman is like ordering for the whole family. And she's like, you can tell she's the one who's in charge, right? And she like takes the menus and she's like, all right, yep, my husband will have this, I'll have this, kids will have this, yep, perfect. And it's just, and then the man's just kind of like sitting there and it's just like, it doesn't, it's so out of balance, it's so out of whack.
That's, and from a man's perspective, and I know I've seen this all the time, even growing up, like I say, with my parents, where we get a lot of this from, where we see it and we learn it as kids, like same there. It's like, because it gets to a point, if the woman is organizing a lot all the time or the man stands back, the man gets to a point where he actually thinks or feels that by letting her organize everything, letting her run that, it's making her feel better. It gets so conditioned that by him stepping back, and that's what I've seen a lot with my parents, but in turn, he can't understand why he feels less significant.
Yeah. Yeah. So the man, by nature, the man wants to take lead, he wants to be in charge, he wants to take care of you and take care of the family. And he wants to be appreciated for it.
That's as simple as...
So, of course, there's some times where the woman needs to organize, but the key is that men, as much as you can, take the lead, organize things.
Even if you don't know what you're doing, remember, we forget a lot of stuff. We only do one thing at a time. So, if you've got to organize dinner or something...
Even if the woman knows like exactly where she wants to go and what she like everything, like still take the charge. Say, yeah. Hey, like I've booked us a
ritual. I was out of whack today. She wanted to go to children. I should have put my foot down.
You should have. And then afterwards, I said I wanted to.
But I know for next time.
Perfect example.
Yeah, but there's so many examples. And take note of this, guys. Yeah. Take note of all these. Write them down. Write of times that you've been in this position where you're unsure why you might have had a fight with an ex-partner or a partner with now, or why you couldn't understand why there was a standoff or you were silent or any of these things. Take note of them because it's all about bringing awareness to what you've got to change or everything you can implement that we're sharing here.
Yeah.
For next time it happens.
Exactly.
Cool.
Yep. So for men, open the car door, organize things as much as you possibly can, like take the lead, take care as much as you can, pay compliments. Yeah. Basic things makes all the difference.
Little basic things stacked up.
And women, it doesn't mean that you're any less smarter or any less powerful or any less boss babe. It doesn't. It just means that you're truly stepping, allowing yourself to be vulnerable, stepping into a feminine energy and allowing your partner to do what he wants to do.
Yeah. Cool.
Okay. So for women, we've kind of covered it off already.
We have. Yeah.
So there's women, a little bit more. To recap, yeah. So for women, let the man take the lead. All right. Let down that facade of being the hardcore, you know, whatever it is you think you are. Let the man take care of you. Let the man take the lead sometimes. Understand, this is something we've gone to soon. Understand that there are times when the man needs the space and time. He needs to go to his man cave. We're going to talk about
that. I'm going to call my bedroom my man cave.
Your bedroom is your man cave.
Yeah, she sneaks in there every now and then.
And once again, show compliments, right? Show your partner appreciation. Show them that you appreciate, whether that be with action, with what you do, or verbally. But yep. You need to show them that you appreciate it. So, like, for example, like yesterday when Steve put the
heat, I'm cold, so he puts the heater on me. All I do is go, oh, that's so nice. Yeah, that's like it. It's like a second.
And inside, I'm like, yes, I did that right. Yes. And that's true. And that's all we need. Yeah. That's all we need. And then what are we going to do next time?
And then we end up going, oh, you're so nice. Yeah.
But you think about it, and you can use it as a simple formula. You do something that makes you feel good, and if it's in relationship, you're going to do it again. See, something makes them feel good. You're going to do it again because you want to feel good.
It makes both of you feel good.
You make both of you feel good, it's going to stack up.
Yeah.
There's going to be a time really shortly where I don't know how I can outdo myself, but nah.
Anyway, type through a yes if this is making sense.
I just want to share something with you first too.
Yeah, if there's any takeaways, like if you're going to start doing some things differently.
What does that say there?
See, that's a feeding is need for significance. God, we've got a lot more to cover.
We have to roll on with this.
All right. It starts with yourself. It's relevant in friendship, partnership. Yeah, exactly, in everything. Even with me and my brother, you know, because my brother and I, we don't have parents. My brother, he took on that role as like being my protector. And you know, one thing he said when I moved from New Zealand to Australia, I remember this. He said, he's like, I'm sorry, I can't give you what Steve gives you in terms of like, you know, how I would always tell him, like, Steve's just always there for me when I need him. And he always gives me, you know, anytime I'm upset, Steve is the person that I call. This is applicable to all relationships, right? Not just romantic relationships. Cool. All right. So shoot through any questions you have. Type there, yes, make sure this is making sense. Cool. So going into the way that each of the sexes deal with stress.
I just noticed how much we've still got to cover.
Yeah.
This is awesome.
Yeah, so full steam ahead. Yeah, we've got 45 minutes to go. All right.
Wow. All
right. So.
Get your pens ready.
Yeah. So we're going to look at the different ways that each masculine, women and men, I'm talking too much, I'm giving time time. Deal with stress. Yeah.
All right, let's talk about the man cave. We've mentioned that. We get to talk about it. Not what happens in the man cave, because that's secret. Nah. you can put any spin on this, so you can have the man cave or whatever it is. Just a man, how they deal with stress or problems or anything. Just remember at the core, we're a problem solver. So if we can't solve a problem, we'll usually step away from wherever it's happening, situational, anything, be anything, a task. We'll go have our own time. Remember the other trait, freedom. So freedom to choose where we go, what we do to solve the problem. And we'll go and think about it. We'll go over it. What will happen is, and you can talk soon about how the woman usually sees this, is when, say, has been not a blue or something and misunderstanding or something, we'll go and we'll think it over. Like, how can we solve this? How can we make it better? How can we make it better? What happens a lot, but, is if we are unable to solve it, man cage is a great place for this. That's where we have our freedom and silence or whatever it is in there.
And by man cave, it can be, you know, men have the ways of coping, watching, turning on the news, turning on sports, reading the newspaper. Yeah.
All stuff I do not recommend.
That's all man cave time.
Yeah. All stuff that I don't recommend. But it's what we do because we want to suppress. We can't solve something. We want to suppress it down. Oh, well, let's find something else to solve. Let's find something else to take our mind off that one because we are unable to solve it. In that time, we need something else to stimulate another challenge. And like I say, we can go and watch the TV if it's a sporting game. We want to see who wins and we want to get involved in that. We want to like commentate or something. That's us commentating. So this has got to go there. You should have kicked it that way. You should have been that way. That's us getting solutions for that there because our attention's gone to that because we're unable to solve
their own problems.
Yeah.
So a really common like theme or example of this, right, is how men, they'll come home from work and let's say that they're stressed out because they weren't able to solve certain problems at work, okay? And then, so they come home.
So this is the way that a man's brain works, is that if he has not been able to, he's got a problem on his mind and he hasn't been able to solve it, he wants to go to the man cave by himself to try and solve this problem. If he cannot solve this problem, he gets stressed, right? And 95% of his brain is trying to solve this problem. Therefore, that's why the woman maybe goes, "You're not present, like you're not here, where are you?" Right? This is why. It's because he's trying to solve the problems of the day, what might have happened. So the way that he copes with it is...
The way that he copes with it. I mentioned one thing there. We look for another thing to stimulate us, another challenge.
Yeah.
And that's why we might go and do something. We might want to go, like I say, we might want to go watch the TV or whatever it is that you do as a man. Like me personally, it's not what I did. I can actually use a big example here, which was just crossed my mind again. When you talk about suppressing things that I can't solve, you want to go back to when I first spoke about my 4-year hiatus or whatever you want to call it from not wanting to be in a relationship. Because I couldn't solve all the issues I had in my past around that. So I blanked it out. So I needed something else to stimulate me. So I just worked really hard. I just went into my work. That's like an extreme example. I was just thinking about that then. But that's how the man thinks and operates. If you can't solve something, you'll suppress. And a lot of problems happen, be it in relationships or not. Even like you hear about with men's mental health and things like that. It's because we suppress. Because if we can't solve something, we put that away. We need to go find something else to solve. So we go do that and then can't solve that, suppress.
Yeah.
Causes major problems.
Exactly. And the problems, how it plays out in a relationship is that the woman will perceive it that, you know, the man comes home, she says, "Hey, honey, how was your day?" If we're being conventional. And, and you know, the man says, "Good." And then they go and they turn on the TV, or they go outside play basketball, or they go and go to their man cave, right? And so the woman perceives, like the woman gets hurt and she's like, you know, what's going on?
What have I done?
Exactly. Which brings us to the other part of this, which is women give a meta report and men give a hunting report.
We can call that. Like, when we give a quick description, and we touched on it earlier about men are hunters, like problem solvers. We've got that one track. We've got our task. We want to hunt that down. We want to solve it. We want to finish it.
Since the beginning of humans, this is how it's been.
We don't
care what's
on the way. There's our target, our animal. We've got to go
kill it,
to feed, to bring home. Job done. That's it. We don't even notice the weather on the way to whatever it is, nothing. But.
Exactly. So if you ask a man, it's like, you know, oh, how was it going to, you know, you're a woman. How was it going to hunt, you know, this evening, whatever?
It was okay.
Right. Well, we got the kill, got the food. Awesome.
Job done. Right?
Then the woman becomes suspicious because we are very different. We're gatherers. So it was our jobs to go out and gather, right? So we needed to remember which way we went, what was going on, what the weather was like, what were the conditions, you know, what berries are poisonous, what fruits are poisonous, what can we eat, how many can we pick, what season does the fruit grow? There's all these different things that we need to remember, right? And this is why. So if a man asks the woman, "How was your day?" And she'll go, "Oh, yeah, well, it was pretty good because blah, blah, blah. And I saw my friend and she told me this. And then I decided that actually I'm going to get my hair cut next week because, you know, it's just going to be way better and I've got split ends and da, 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 da." Right? And we give this full meta report, we can call it. So what Tony Roberts calls it. We give it this
great analogy, awesome analogy. Yeah.
Full on detailed report. And this is the way that our brain works, right? When women are with women, this is how we share, you know, we give details, we talk about it, we share our feelings, we share what happened. Whereas men are not like that. Okay. So what happens when when people don't understand the differences between the way we're actually programmed, like since the beginning of human time, then it causes conflict. Because when Steve comes home and I say, how are you? And he says, good. Then he goes and does something else, right? I'm like, what's going on? Why is he not talking to me? You know, does he not, he doesn't care about me, blah, 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 blah. And I start, right? And I start getting all resentful and I maybe make up stories in my head. And
yeah, but even me, and I'm like, trust, oh.
Distrusting him because I don't understand, because for women, we don't understand that.
I don't understand when she comes home every day and wants to tell me, like, what her friend's, like, bag looked like and why she carried it on a different arm and things like that. And in my head, because I don't, if I didn't understand the meta report, if you want to call it that, I just want to say, well, yeah, this is what I've done. I'll catch you after. I've got stuff to solve. I don't understand why she has to come and do this every day. But this is another thing. If you've got awareness of this from both sides, you know how to be more present as a man and just listen to a little bit more of whatever's got to happen. And same the other way. You understand that, all right, my day was good. Well, he just needs his freedom. He needs to go to the man cave or whatever.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So we can understand that in order, so we can go, okay, cool. I now understand that if there was stress, problems in his day that he hasn't been able to solve, he is like, it is not possible for him to be present with me right now. So he needs to go off and have his time and his space, his man cave time, to distract himself in some way, overcome it in some way, so that he can come back and be present with you. So the reason he needs that time is because that's the way they are. And it doesn't mean they don't care about you. It means that they want to come back and be present with you. So, Steve, did you want to share a quick exercise that...
Just quickly before that, like a couple of things that just to keep in mind, knowing that that's how a woman is. We want to share everything that happened today. Be very mindful that if you're coming home to share something with your partner and there's a lot of stuff and a lot of problems in the day, just remember the man might be present listening, but if you're going to unload problem after problem after problem, our mind's going to go, oh, shit, too many problems. It's another reason where you might be like, oh, well, what have I done or anything. Even though we're listening, we've got the first problem in our mind. Like, what, another one, we nearly implode. Because we want to solve stuff. So just be very mindful of that.
They can't think of all these.
No, we can't.
They're not like us. How we're like, ah.
Which is awesome.
Exactly. Like, yeah. It's a good thing. Because and that's why you balance each other out.
And another reason, we touched on this earlier about the hands up in the room, like how you need to feel safe. With the meta report, going out to pick out all the berries, why you have to remember everything. Because you've got,
you must,
like,
share that information.
You've got to share that information, like everything. You've got to share that because you need to be safe. You want to protect whoever else needs to go out. If you have to pass on that information, they have to feel safe too. Whereas a man's like, we don't notice that. We just need to go there, get that, come back, done.
Yeah, because we feel, because exactly back then, if we didn't share that information, then, you know, if something happened to us, then people are not going to know. Which berries are poisonous, which berries aren't poisonous,
exactly.
What time to go out, what time to get them. Right, and then people will...
So much cool stuff with this, guys, that interlinks all back to the basic traits, and having awareness of what it is. I think that's key.
Exactly.
That's absolute key.
Yeah, so once again, type 3, yes, if this is, making sense, and... He's a kid. And type 3, any questions you may have, or key takeaways from this. So Steve, did you want to do a little routine or exercise for men so that they, you know, when they come home or just if they're experiencing any kind of stress,
yeah,
they can unload the stress and then once again be present.
Yeah, men and women can do this, but at the basis of it
but
is...
But men need it more.
Men, well... From me looking back, something that I've been consistent on was huge for me, huge, because of what I've mentioned, suppressing stuff, especially from our day, for our work, dealing with whatever it is, we suppress it. We can't solve it, suppress. So this routine is very, very powerful. Like I say, men and women can use it. If definitely take notes on it if you want to utilize this yourself. I know later on down the track you've got your own spin on this, and even even I have, that shortens it down, but it's all based on bringing awareness to your problems, having an understanding. Is that? Yeah. Is that what you wanted?
Okay. But we were
going to
do it at the end.
Well, this is what it is. No, this is cool anyway.
Yeah.
This is cool anyway. Wait. I've noticed in partnerships, Beck's got something there.
All right, Beck. Sorry, we're just double checking something. There.
Oh, yeah. Cool. Oh, that's all right.
I have noticed in partnerships that exactly right, and it's so simple. It's just about like understanding that we are different creatures, men and women. We really are. And so once we can have a bit of respect and compassion for the differences, because it's beautiful that we have those differences, then so much conflict can be avoided. We can have so much more understanding, right? The men can understand that, you know, if women are upset and, you know, they're going blah, 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 you know, that we don't want to be fixed. We don't want a solution. You know, women, we share our problems just because we value loving connections and relationships, and we just want to be able to express ourselves, and that's it. And we just want someone to be there, be present, and listen. So when guys can understand that, it's perfect. And that's one of the awesome things, like with me and Steve, is that when I'm upset and I'm getting all crazy or I'm very emotional, crying, then Steve is just there and listens. And then, you know, I let out what I need to let out. He's there. And then at the end, we're usually even closer than we were before, because I've let go of what I needed to let go of. And yeah. I'm so grateful and appreciative of Steve having just been there for me.
Yeah. On that note, I think it's going to be better to do that at the end anyway. Yeah. So we can skip straight into what's next.
Yeah. Awesome. Okay.
Yeah, it is important, and this is something everyone can utilize, and that's why I think it's going to work better at the end, like you picked up on, which is fantastic. Thank you.
Stop complimenting.
What have I done?
It comes once I've wants to work on themselves.
That is awareness of himself. Yep.
Yeah, I'm finally with the man that is awareness of themselves and with his brother. Yeah, awesome. Definitely cool. All right, so.
Well, we done a lot last night planning this.
Yeah, so next exercise, 6 human needs.
Definitely write this down. This is huge as well.
So there are 6 human needs. And these are needs that every single human being has, hence why they're called human needs. Surprise, surprise. And it's what we all need these needs to be fulfilled in order to be balanced and be happy. Simple, it's simple as that. Okay. So we're going to run through what they are, and then we're going to do a cool little exercise on this that's really going to help you guys with this. So the first human need is certainty. Okay, so we need to have a level of certainty, and that's just basic instinct on wanting to feel safe and secure, right? Wanting to feel trust, wanting to feel reliability, comfortable, secure, safety. And this is a very masculine energy.
And we've been mentioning these all the way through. And once you write these down and go back through the recording, you're going to notice a lot of the stuff that we've been talking about in the trace and everything that links straight into that.
Yeah, it's all interlinked.
Yeah.
So this is a need every human has, right? We need to know that we need to have a level of certainty and know there are some things that are for sure and we can feel safe in that, okay? And so this is just, you know, for in life in general, but also with a relationship. You need to make sure that you trust your partner, you rely on them, this level of certainty. Next one is?
Well, variety. Hmm. Yeah, that's key. And depends how you want to look at it.
It's a feminine energy.
It is. And we all need all of these needs. Keep that in mind too, even though it's a feminine energy and variety, we need to continue to change, to mix things up a bit. especially in a relationship front, I think that's key too, when things might be getting a bit stale or whatever you want to put on it, it's because there's a lack of variety. It's actually a human need to have that variety.
So you need to experience new things. You need to change it up sometimes. So a really good example that Tony Robbins gives is it's like, you know, looking at certainty and variety. It's like, look, raise your hands, everyone in the room who's rented a video that they've already seen before, right? People raise their hand. He's like, yeah, get a fucking life. And then, but then he goes on and explains. He's like, yeah, because that fulfills the two first human needs, right? It fulfills the need for certainty because you know that it's a good movie, but you've probably watched it, you know, a few years ago, meaning that you've forgotten some of the things that happened. So, you know, there's going to be variety in there as well, right? So, yeah, new, trying new things, new activities, meeting new people, changing it up. Yeah, variety. Third one is significance. So we all need to feel that we're, we're special in some way.
We do need to feel it. And just know too, when you, when these ones, sometimes you need a little bit more than others, like significance is like, if you're not getting that significance, you're going to go searching for it and you're going to do things that like.
So if you're part, like in a relationship, so like some people will do, there's positive and negative ways you can fulfill these needs. Mm. So some people will resort to violence. And that's their way of feeling significant. Like, yeah, I'm tough and I get in fights, right? That could be fulfilling their need for significance. Or they could be doing something really cool, contributing back in their community, which is, is still fulfilling the same need, significance. They're being recognized. They feel special, but it's positive. It's healthy.
Yeah. No, that's true.
And in relationship?
In relationship too. It's like where a lot of people get out of, would you say, a balance with the man feeling significance, feeling he has to be an authority or anything like that. He's actually fulfilling his need for significance.
Yeah, by taking the leadership role.
By taking the leadership role. But a lot of men get that wrong. They do get that wrong. They think they've got to be authority. But what we've talked about earlier about leading the situation, yeah, knowing the energies. That. Yeah, and that's what it is there.
And it's the same thing. If the woman is being too dominant and masculine, then the man is going to feel insignificant. And so he's going to try and fulfill those needs in other ways, which may not be healthy.
Yeah.
Fourth.
Love and connection. I'll be honest here. It's like, this is one that I needed to fulfill, but I didn't know. I was not aware of. And just know these human needs too, about yourself. You've got to fulfill these somehow. But I know coming into a relationship, that's something that I definitely get fulfilled. That I was missing out. Like, yeah, I worked on my self-love and all that, but in a relationship sense, that's something that I really need to fulfill because I hadn't had it before.
Yeah.
So that was key for me and something I've really, really noticed.
Yeah, and that's a very feminine energy to lead with. So these are, just quickly, a little note here, the human needs that Tony Robbins gives, they're also, like, if you look at them, compare them to the chakras, it's like the same thing pretty much because, you know, it's the fourth need. If you go to the fourth chakra, it's the heart chakra, which is all about unconditional love, the giving and receiving of unconditional love. So these are all similar. And like, for example, number one, first need, certainty, that's your root chakra. It's your first thing. So that's,
yeah, you're awesome. Very good at all that stuff. Yeah.
okay. What are we up to? Growth.
These last two we're like massive on, and you'll notice by our journey over the last nearly 2 years or whatever it is, these next two are huge. It's growth. And you guys that are on here, and this is part of growth work, if you want to call that. That's actually a human need. We have to evolve and grow continually.
If you're standing still, just doing the same thing, not learning new things, it doesn't matter how perfect your life is, you're going to start to feel unfulfilled because that's a need that we all have. Yeah,
it is. It is a need. And it's something that, another thing that I wasn't aware of until I started to do the growth work and do the personal development.
Yeah.
It's
a funny thing because it's like, it's this, people have this crazy idea that, you know, like, oh, once I get to this level of success or I have this and I'm this and I do this, whatever, then that's my life's gonna be perfect. But what happens is so many people, they reach their goals,
they're happy for a moment, and yeah, they're like, what's next?
What's happening? Yeah.
You're like, what's next? Oh, I don't, cool, this is cool, but what's next? You know, you've always got to keep going and learning.
Yeah.
Progress equals happiness.
Yeah.
As Tony Robbins says.
Well, as everyone puts out there and you see, if you're not growing, you're dying. So true.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Jesus.
Yeah. So you've got to be making progress in something, like within yourself and within relationships as well, like that you're growing together, you know, you're doing new things together, that your relationship is evolving.
So. Yeah.
Cool. And the sixth need.
Contribution. This is different for everybody. Everybody sees contribution differently. They contribute differently. But it's a human need. You just got to remember that. In some way, you got to contribute. You've touched on a lot of people in life. They'll go through life and like they might have success and but wonder why they don't feel fulfilled. It comes back to contribution. And we see this very similar. I think this is important too. Knowing these human needs and having similar views on them, just in fulfilling, it helps in a relationship. It really does.
Yeah, because for both of us, yes, everyone needs to fulfill this need. And it can be fulfilled in different ways. Like it could just be like that you donate to some kind of charity. It could be that you, you know, you sponsor a child in Africa. Or it could be that you're like fucking Tony Robbins and impacting millions of people around the world. Like whatever, however big a scale it's on, it needs to be fulfilled for everyone.
Yeah.
So, but for us, that's one of our, what really connects us a lot is our, it's very much
very
one
similar.
Of our core values.
Same as growth. They're core values if you want to go down that track too.
Yeah. Growth and contribution, core values of ours. Yeah, absolutely. Cool. All right. So, exercise on clarifying. So, we're going to do an exercise, right? You're going to do this right now, live on the line. So you know what the human needs are right now. So we'll just recap them so that you can write them down. So certainty, variety, significance, love and connection,
growth, contribution.
Contribution. That's six. Yeah.
Because you've got seven fingers up.
In the only way, because there's seven chakras, your crown chakra. Yeah, those are the six needs. All right, so what you're going to do now is, you know, write down, right, the six human needs. And then I want you to write down where you are right now in terms of your fulfillment on a scale of 1 to 10. So 10 being super fulfilled, 1 being like, fuck, I'm so fucking unfulfilled in this area.
Yeah.
For this need. Okay. So, for example, let's say number one with certainty. Let's say that you have, you're financially insecure. Is it a word? Insecure.
You're the language teacher.
Anyway. Let's say that you're like your job hopping all the time, or like you don't know when your income is coming in. Or let's say that you're moving house all the time, like you don't have a routine, like all this crazy stuff is happening.
Even relationship then, on the relationship front.
Yeah. Then for certainty, you might put a lower number, like a 2 or 3, something like that. For example, with love and connection, if you're, you know, you're super closed off, if you're single right now, you don't have a good tight relationship with your family, you don't have many friends, then you'd probably, again, put like a 1 or 2 or 3.
Yeah.
All right? So go through each of the human needs. Where are you on a scale of 1 to 10 in your life right now? Okay? So
be honest with yourself here too. It's like this is for your benefit.
It's not any judgment. It's just like complete honesty, being honest with yourself. Where am I right now?
Where are you? Yeah.
Otherwise, you can't do anything to improve it, right? If you're not being honest.
And if you're a 10.
No one's a 10.
But yeah, we'll give them a minute.
Yeah, so just to give you a minute or so.
Yeah, to click through them.
And once you're done, you can put in a bit of feedback on what number you are. What a shame Tracy couldn't jump on.
She'll get the recording and she'll love it. As soon as you've done that there, just quickly type something into the box.
Yeah, so type there a couple, just a couple of them.
What pops up?
What was your rating?
Yeah.
Maybe like your highest, what was your highest rating? What was your lowest rating? That's good because you can see like where you need to improve, where you need to take some action. This may be a bit delayed as well because then too. Alright.
This is still rolling out. That's awesome.
Alright,
let's see. Going all out.
Oh, okay, so certainty of 4, variety is 7, significance 9. So it is for you, right? So you feel very special. That's good though.
That's awesome. Yeah.
You must have a good partner.
Jeffrey.
Oh, Jeffrey. love and connection, 8. Beautiful. Growth, 8. Awesome. You feel like you're growing. Fucking growth, that's like everything to me. And contribution. Mm. Contribution, 7. Awesome. That's really cool.
That is really, really cool. That's it.
So, what was the number 4? Certainty. That's interesting, though, because, you know, when... If we relate this back to, you know, the chakras, healing your energy center, money. Yeah. if you're talking about this from a, you know, energetic, spiritual point of view, you have your chakras, right? The bottom one is like, you know, like our physical sense of physically being here. Like, are we safe? Do we have food? Do we have shelter? It's like being like really human, right? Then as you go up each chakra, it's like going up a level of consciousness. So when you want to start healing your life, it's always important to actually start with the first chakra, your root chakra, which is around certainty. And it's what so many people need healing with, because so many people have things, stuff around money.
Yeah, massively.
Which is a huge thing. So what I would say, my point is that if your root chakra, like if your certainty rating is quite low, then the other needs, they may not be as fulfilled as you think they are, if that makes sense, because you must begin doing the work on the lower ones first. If that makes sense. It may not make sense if you don't know anything about chakras. But anyway, just thought I'd drop that in there. It's relevant. All right, so Beck said
moving out, cyclone. Money. That's fair enough, and it's reason to bring that uncertainty. It definitely is.
Yeah.
That's all them things.
Cool. All right, so next up, what you're going to do is, where are we?
Yeah, it's something, because all this stuff we're bringing awareness to, it's about what you can do to improve these areas.
Yeah, and looking at the time, I think.
Yeah.
So what you're going to do now is look at, okay, cool, you've been really honest on where you're at with each of these needs. What can you do? What could you do, like right now in your life, to become more fulfilled in each of these areas? All right. And so even if, for example, with you, Beth, if it's like money, you can say, okay, like how can I start increasing my income, or how can I start having a better relationship with my money? How can, you know, like, do I set up a new budget, or, you know, do I start a little side project that's earning me more money? Do I start another part-time job? Like, right? So start to look for ways in each of those categories that you can become more fulfilled. Because the important thing is, if you're not fulfilled, right, within these needs, you're not going to be happy in a relationship.
It's as simple as that.
Action. Yeah.
Take action on that.
So because of time, we were going to get you to do this like live, type through some feedback, but we're like, this, still got a bit more to share.
That's a cool one to go away and think about too, because you know what you might do when you have a look at it and you question how you can improve? You might see that the ratings you've given in some of them areas to say, actually, wait, probably a bit lower because I can actually improve this, this, and this more. That's why it's really important to be honest with this. It's a good, this is a really good exercise too. Yeah. They all are. They're all awesome. Interlink them all, and yeah, that's why we're going to go over time.
Yeah, exactly. So just to recap that exercise, so you go over, you write out each of your six human needs. You rate them on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being that they're completely unfulfilled, 10 being that they're super fulfilled. And then you want to go through each category again, write out how, what can I do like to become more fulfilled in these areas so that I'm more happy and more imbalanced within myself and within my relationships.
I think just before we end that one too, just remember with all these human needs, this is all back to you. And if you're in a relationship, 100% each. It's no 50-50. You want to go, well, why I bring this to the table? I've got to fulfill this need for this person. Yes, you complement each other. That's important, but just know it's 100% and 100%. I think that's a really important one.
Yeah. It's not that you're just giving 50 and then your partner's giving 50. You're giving 100%. Yeah. 100%. 100%.
Yeah. They're your human needs. Just bringing awareness to yours, having awareness of your partner's, 100% yours, 100% yours. That's definitely key.
Yeah. Definitely.
Cool.
Did you want to chat on men being leaders?
We're going to really, really, really rush through this. But that's okay if we go over. We'll this has been quick. Really, really cool.
Yeah.
Men being leaders, this is important. And this is anyone we'll being leaders on. Too. We've touched on it a lot through here, some of the simple things that, that can be done. If you are a man and you want to step into that leadership role, be it in relationships, be it even in like working or anything like that, relationships as a whole, just being that better leader, there's things you can do which help you become that person. Things like I was going to touch on before with the rituals, that's a big part of it. How do men go through their day? How do they solve their problems quicker? Because we're problem solvers.
We're going to go into that now.
Yeah, that's, and it links into us actually being better leaders. Being more masculine actually means by default we become better leaders. It's as simple as that. There are many tools you can use. There are many things. But even just having the awareness of everything we've gone through tonight is going to make you become a better leader if you put a lot of it into action.
So it's also good for your, like, in your job and your, like, your career, your business, everything, not just romantic relationships.
No, exactly. It's really, really important. But what we want to touch on now, we're not going to get through this. Rituals are huge. They've been massive in everything we have done.
Yeah.
They have been huge because you think through life.
Repetition is the mother's
repetition. Story. So we've conditioned ourselves with habits and everything, some good, some bad, for many, many years. And everything we've touched on tonight, reactions from certain events, how we've done that. You've got to break them, but we've got to recondition new habits, new ways of dealing with things, new ways of solving problems. That's what we've got to do. And to do that, rituals are super, super important. And they've been at the core of a lot of the stuff we've been able to, what would you say, to change. I think they're a good way to bring change in, but to really solidify it going forward.
Like real change, real transformation.
Yeah. Now we have a morning routine and a nighttime routine. I think for the purpose of this, the morning routine is awesome, but the purpose of this, this training here, especially for the men, but both men and women can use this because it's really, really important to have a look back at your day. You don't want to go to bed with anything. You don't want to, if you are dealing with problems, be it in relationship or not, whatever it is, you just really want to have a look at the end of your day and say, all right, this could have been done better. Yeah, it helps you feel better about yourself too on a personal level, this does, because it'll highlight some of your wins as well.
Yeah.
And like I say, as a man, remember, we're problem solvers.
Yeah.
So this is really about solving the problems of the day.
Rituals are everything.
Rituals are huge.
So the awesome thing about this is that you can do it whether you're single or in a relationship. So both Steve and I did this for a long time, every single night, even before we were together. But now that we're in a relationship, we've adapted it and we actually do it together.
And we've even gone to the point where we like writing it down is really good. And I absolutely suggest you write this down every day, because writing it down, you can talk about it, you can ask questions like we do now. But writing it down every day and you get to know the questions, there's something you can ask yourself during the day too.
Yeah.
But we do, we have changed this a bit to suit us. Like, she wants to feel special and that. Oh, can you ask me my debrief and all this? Can you ask a question? And I found this is really, really helpful too, because it like brings us closer together too, because we're not holding anything back at the end of the day from each other. But we might have had an issue with each other during the day, but these simple questions can bring that out with no judgment, because we know what we're doing. We're looking at, oh, how can we do things better?
Yeah.
So by asking each other my first question, you can change this like two things you could have done better today.
So are you gonna give the questions?
That's a question. I'm gonna do the questions we do, I think, for the sake of relationship.
Yeah. Okay, so the questions are
Yeah, I'm gonna ask her. How about that? Do you want that?
Yeah, live example.
Live. And then there are a longer versions of this. Definitely, it's something we're going to talk about at the end, I think, too, when it comes to rituals. But on the relationship front, what we've been able to develop, this one, this is cool. Two things you feel you could have done better today.
Two things I think I could have done better today. Okay, one of them I'm not going to share on here. Okay, I know.
There's definitely something I'm not going to share on here. Well, it's got to be. No, I'm not going to.
First thing.
Oh, wow.
First thing is that what we mentioned before. I'm not mentioning that. So when I came home, Steve said to me, let's go out for lunch. And I said, yeah, let's go to Chill, which is a cafe. So I chose the place. And funnily enough, it's almost like a lesson or something, because we got there and it's actually really windy. And I was like, I'm cold. I'm getting goosebumps.
Yeah.
Even though it's like 25 degrees. Yeah, and then later, like, Steve realized, he's like, no, I should have put my foot down. And I actually said, like, while we were there, well, we should have gone to this other place. And, there was one thing Steve's like, I should have put my foot down. And
that's said, one thing I could have done better.
Let's go. I want to take you to this other place.
Yeah, that's definitely one thing I could have done better.
Take the lead more, decide where we're going to go for lunch.
Yeah.
It's something that's so simple. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Number two, this is like the hardest question for me.
It'll be the hardest question for everyone, especially if you're doing it in this sense where we're asking each other.
Okay, I could have woken up earlier and done the exercise this morning. Yeah, that's what I could have done. I didn't do it.
I'm glad you finally admitted to that.
That's so honest. All right, shut up. Next one.
Next one. Two wins from today.
Okay, two wins. Running an awesome live workshop, win number one. another win, having lunch with you, and then spending quality time with you.
She's in my head with these. So many times we have similar answers for this. But no, that's so true. Now, one way we can look at this too is the night before. This is a routine, remember? This is daily stuff. This happens constant repetition to continually bring awareness to the problems, how to solve them. Like I say, your wins every day. So the night before, we set priorities. Like priorities, be it if you want to put a relationship sense on this, what are your priorities for the day in the relationship, or just a general day? This is really important. You got to set yourself priorities the night before. What have you got to get done tomorrow? What have you got to complete? For men, this is super important because we need to complete stuff.
Yeah, to feel confident.
So if you're going every day, you're not setting yourself anything, how can you complete anything? You've got stuff to do, but bring awareness to that. So with you, four priorities, how'd you go today? Are you getting done?
yes. I got the most important things done today. Yeah.
No, that's good. That's what it's about. Same with me. I got the most important things done today, except Telstra, but that's out of my hands. I cannot complete that. But that's important for me as a man. I've got to complete. If I set myself tasks, I've got to complete them. If I don't, remember, I suppress them.
Yeah.
But if I've got a daily routine where I can unload these and like, all right, I didn't finish that today. All right, what's the solution? Okay, I can solve it this way tomorrow. It's what it's about. Instead of suppressing it, getting it out. It's so important. Yeah. The other thing too, you set tomorrow's priorities. Getting up early, walking to work. you go. There's that look again. Now, what are your priorities for tomorrow?
Tomorrow's priorities. Tomorrow's priorities are, yes, getting up early, doing an awesome morning routine, doing exercise, replying to messages. I've got a lot of messages on my phone, getting back to people that I need to get back to, and promoting the recording of this workshop, getting it out to as many people as we can.
Absolutely. Now, mine are morning routine, message as many people about this and everything else related to business for me, getting on the phone to Telstra to solve that major, major problem. And also I've got to talk to my accountant tomorrow, which is really, really important. They're my priorities. So no driving you to work. It's not a priority. All right. This is really cool. And this is something to really get you thinking. Like, you've had a look at your day, you've gone through, it's a very quick debrief. This is designed to be really quick,
short
and sweet. And it's awesome with this interaction doing it as well. Now have a think about it. Like, this is not before. If tomorrow's already finished, it's already finished. Describe it in a sentence or two words, three words, whatever it is. How did it go and how did that make you feel? And what you want to do is you want to, like, it's gone awesome. You've completed your priorities. Everything's gone amazingly. Great people, you've had conversations, all that. But just in a sentence, how did it go? How do you feel now? Tomorrow's already happened. How did it go? How do you feel?
I feel awesome. I got everything that I wanted to do done and it just happened easily and I was excited about it and it was fun and I connected with cool people and we got really good feedback on our workshop and we spent some more quality time together and finish having a lovely evening and feeling happy and satisfied and fulfilled.
She sort of stole mine, except the quality time together was quality time in my man cave. So I was happy because I got some freedom. No, but you see the power of that. I think that's really, really important. Like I say, there's an extended version of that. Definitely ones that you can do by yourself. We're going to mention something about that after. Yeah. How you can learn that.
Yeah. So do you want to, we can email the, like, a sheet of the questions maybe. Do you want to recap the questions?
Them questions then, two things you can improve about your day, or what two things can you improve, how can you improve them? Like I say, we can send them out in a message to everyone who's registered for this. two wins in your day? No, you're not. Two wins from your day. It's so important to bring awareness to your wins. If you're highlighting your problems, of course you want to bring attention to your wins. That's really important. Four priorities for the next day. Write out your four priorities. Like I say, if you're a man, you've got to complete this stuff. Maybe if you're a woman, you've got to complete it too. But it's important to set them priorities. Then just in a sentence, describe your day's already happened. It went amazing. How did it go? How do you feel? If you want to unload and do massive, exciting, right, do it. If you're a man, it's like, it went good. I felt amazing. Let's say it links into everything we've been talking. Got shit done. It links into everything we've been teaching tonight and talking about tonight.
Yeah. So what two things can I do better tomorrow? What are two wins? What are
your four priorities?
Four priorities.
Yep. And your little power sentence, how the day went. Yeah.
How the day's going.
And how it made you feel.
I was gonna say results created, but that's from the longer version.
That's the longer version. We have got a longer, more powerful version, which is the same basis, but purpose of this.
Yeah. So you can do that individually, you can do that for yourself and do it. It's powerful when you do it every single night, night after night. You become so much more self aware about what you can do better and you can obviously do it with your partner as well.
I think yeah. what we're going to do with this one now.
Well, this is just an exercise.
Yeah, and this is something you can do. Definitely write these down. And what we're going to finish with, we're just going to focus on one area. These are your life areas, if you will, areas of your life. Wow, we've jam-packed a lot in here, but take note of these definitely. This can evolve to so much more. Work in all these areas. It's got to be needed to create that balance. As with everything we've done here, every exercise, this is really important to bring awareness. But just for now, I'll read them out to you. Number one, of course, is your health. That's the number one area. Take a little bit of time so you can write these down. And there'll be the recording anyway. Number two is wealth. Third one is contribution. Fourth one, career, business, or purpose, life purpose. Next one, relationships. Next one is passions and enjoyment. And finally, family. Yeah. Now, you can have a chat about the exercise, yeah. what you can do with this.
Well, look, it's really simple. It's just, this is really simply about getting clear on, like, what is the vision that you want in your life? What do you want in your life? Okay, so, like, this is so important to know with for yourself, but it's also so important to know when you're attracting, like, if you're single right now, you're wanting to get into a relationship. Because you need to have a similar vision to your partner.
Yeah.
So when you write this out, so an example is, you know, for your health, go into as much detail as you can and be as specific as possible. So with your health, you know, write about, like, how do you want to be feeling? What's your energy like? What do you look like? What, you know, what kind of food are you eating? What are you putting in your body? How much water are you drinking? Do you detoxes? Do you, like, what kind of exercise are you doing, right?
You're one of them wobble machines.
What is it that you want, right, in the area of health? How do you want your health to be, okay? And wealth, how much money do you want to be earning, right? A good way to come up with an aligned figure is to actually look at, well, what kind of lifestyle do I want to be living? Look at the prices of stuff. Like, actually go and online and look it up and, you know, add it all together in a kind of rough estimate lump sum and say, cool, this is the amount of money that I want to be earning per year or per month that's going to make me the most happy and comfortable, right? That's going to allow me to live the lifestyle I want to live. Contribution. How do you want to contribute? How do you want to give back? Who do you want to help? Right? Do you want to sponsor a child? Do you want to impact millions of people? Like, what does that look like for you? Okay. So you can even write out like I am, which is really powerful.
I have, even more powerful.
I have. Yeah, it depends on the grammar. But yeah, like, exactly. But for example, like with health, like I am a bikini model or I am a body
sculptor. I am a mankini model, no.
I've just won a body sculpting contest, right? Or a contribution. I am sponsoring a child in Africa. It feels amazing. Like, write it out yeah. as much as, like, get clear, ask yourself, what do I want in this area? For career or business purpose. So purpose meaning, what is your life purpose? Because we really believe that everyone is here for a reason. You have a purpose here. You have a role to play within humanity, within your life. You have things to learn. So how are you fulfilling that?
I think with that one too, a lot of people aren't aware of what their purpose is yet. That's a key thing. Just know there are ways you can work that out. There are. And this has something to do with it.
Yeah, and that's a whole other thing. I mean, my purpose is what drives me, and it's helped me to understand everything that's happened in my life.
that's a whole other thing.
It is a whole other thing, yeah.
Yeah, that's what we work with people on, is like digging into their purpose and things.
Yeah.
Yeah, so write it out. What kind of, do you want to have a business? Do you want to be like an artist? What does that look like? You know, what paintings are you doing? Again, as much detail as possible.
Yeah.
Relationships. Here's where you can really go into a lot of detail. So when I was single, the work I was doing is like, I wrote out the characteristics. You know, I wrote, I want someone who's funny, someone who makes me laugh, someone who gets me, right? Someone who I can, but most importantly, someone I can trust, someone I can rely on, someone who's always there for me. Someone who's fit and healthy, who has the same values, right? You can just write it out in so much detail.
Someone who snores, apparently. Someone who drives me to work every day.
I mean, you can even
write. She got it right. This stuff works.
Then passions and enjoyment. Again, like, what is the ideal your lifestyle look like in this area? So are you jet skiing every day? That's what I want to be doing. Are you horse riding, like, regularly? Are you, you know, going out dancing? Are you fishing with Steve? Like, where are you fishing, right?
At the back of my man cave.
And then, and then last one is family, right? So what do you want to?
Yeah, with family, and just know with all these areas, it's about you and your picture of it, your ultimate picture of it.
Your ideal vision for your life.
Don't worry about these areas. Don't worry about saying, well, I need this, but I've got to, because of my partner or because of this, I've got to change it. No, this is all about you, you finding out what your ideal vision is in these areas. That's the point of it.
Yeah. Awesome.
Making up words now.
I'm an English teacher.
Every box of the list I wrote down 12 months ago. Wow.
Jeff ticks every box.
Except for snoring.
I think that just comes. I don't snore, so like, you don't even need to ask for it. It just comes. I don't remember writing that down either. He makes some weird noises in his sleep.
Freaks her out. She does stuff and I just don't bring awareness to it because I don't want to offend her. I'm like, oh well, I'll just listen to it and take it on.
So I'm an angel when I sleep.
Yeah. Yeah. She one a very loud angel.
All right. So that is apparently,
there you go. Cool. Own it.
That's the exercise. That is the exercise for that.
Yeah.
Just get into as much detail as possible. That's the key. And then obviously if you're in a relationship, you can compare it with your partner, you know, chat about it. And, you know, if you're single, it's awesome to know all this stuff, because then it's like, when you do go out on a date with someone, you can be like, so, you know, what do you like to do for fun? Like, but not just on a shallow, superficial level. Like,
Yeah.
Do you connect with this
person? This is something that both of us have done this repeatedly, this exercise, all the time, and how we knew that there was a good match there, because we're so similar in so many of these areas. It works. It doesn't mean you have to like everything and all that, but it is so similar, because all these areas, your visions, have all got to point to something very, very similar. Very, very similar. That's really important.
Exactly. All right.
Now, what we are going to do here, this is special on many levels. Now, we've talked about the life areas, and because this is pretty relationship-based, it's not...
Last exercise.
This is the last exercise. This is definitely something to go back to in all the areas, but for the purpose of this tonight, we wanted to do it with relationships. This is if you're in a relationship, if you wanted to improve,
If you have relationship goals,
yeah, this is something that you can do that can lock in that goal on a subconscious level for you. This is super powerful. Important, and it's super, super powerful. Like with the earlier guided stuff we did, the meditation earlier, if you want to call it that, have a space where it's quiet, no interruptions, you're by yourself, especially if you're doing this over the recording and everything like that. And just know at the end of this too, just time to yourself, it's super, super important.
Yeah.
Because this is the deeper level stuff here.
Yeah.
That is really important. And like I say, we're gonna do this on relationships, and it does. This locks it in. We talk about attracting the ideal relationship in, or the ideal person, like with ourselves. We talk about that, but we never talk about the real deep stuff that we've done. This is something, yes, we can work on peeling back the layers, but you still want to attract in that. You want to have that ideal vision of your relationship.
Be intentional about who you want to attract.
Yeah, absolutely. And this is an exercise that really does do that.
What do we All got? Right, so we'll just check this before we do the exercise. Apparently I snort also.
Love the interaction here. It's really, really cool.
Oh, law of attraction. Exactly.
Do you want to do this one or do you want me to?
Think about.
I'm always bringing surprises. Variety.
How was it? Variety for them.
There you go.
Cool. All right. So music on this one.
Yeah, well, I think we'll do music on this one. This is really cool. This is a lot different than the early one we done too, guys. This is cool.
All right. So, cool. All right. So, making sure that you're comfortable.
You won't cry again. This is something to get excited about. This is a cool one. This is really, really cool.
And crying is good. It's healthy. It's natural.
Actually, you can cry about this. It's how excited you will get about this. Happy, yes.
All right. First word problems.
Yeah.
All right, so just closing your eyes, getting comfortable. So I'm just going to ask you a few questions. I don't want you to overthink anything, just see what comes up for you. So, thinking about relationships, how is it possible that you don't have it now? What specifically is your desired outcome? Where are you now? What will you see, hear, feel when you have it? What will you have to do to get it? What else could you do? How will you know when you have it? What will this outcome get for you or allow you to do? Is it only for you? What is the first step? Where, when, how, and with whom do you want it? What do you have now, and what do you need to get your outcome? Have you ever had or done this before? Do you know anyone who has? Can you act as if you have it? For what purpose do you want this? What will you gain or lose if you have it? Does this outcome increase or decrease choice? what will happen if you get it? What won't happen if you get it? What will happen if you don't get it? What won't happen if you don't get it? All right. So just opening your eyes again, coming back to now, to the present.
You're good at that.
So what?
We don't have to ask.
Bex is fucking well.
Well, do we have to ask how she felt? Wow.
Awesome. Commence heavy dance. Wow. I feel your voice through this fucking well. I was totally present then. Yay. That's awesome, Bex. So cool. This, once again, this is a tool that you now have that you can use over and over again. And your conscious mind probably doesn't register what the hell just went on. But that's perfect because it's good because this is actually working on your unconscious mind.
Yeah.
Which is where the real change happens.
Where the real change happens. And like I said, that last exercise, it ties in everything tonight as well. Go back to the recording definitely in relationship area. If you're single, if you're not even in it.
We've jam-packed so much into this in 3 hours, guys. So we can only...
3.5 hours, there you go.
Yeah.
We can only
focus for, so long. So there's probably a lot that you didn't grasp the first time you watched this. So, yeah, you've got this recording for life. So go back and watch again, take notes.
Definitely, definitely. And like I say, that last exercise there, all your life areas... Use it for goal setting. It's a deep goal setting exercise. You've got the guided stuff there.
Yeah.
Tanya's amazing voice there at the end, and I'm like, wow.
Embarrassing me.
Really?
Holy shit, yes. Well, that was my problem before, like this. It hasn't all just been power couple.
Aww. Oh, wow.
Thanks, Beth. That's really, really nice. That's cool. Really appreciate that. Mm-hmm. We just do it because we want to help people. We want to teach people this stuff because it's made such a difference in our lives.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, I remember, you usually only see the good things on Facebook, right? And everyone's like, oh, you too, like, perfect. And, all of this and honeymoon phase, blah, blah, blah. But, it really, there's been... a lot in this. It has been very up and down. Like, I remember the first time that Steve hugged me, like just a hug. I freaked out.
I was freaking out too, don't worry.
Because there was fear there, because I think both of us knew, we already had this connection and we both knew that if we were going to take it further, it was going to be something really real where we were going to have to put our bullshit aside and really open up and
It took a bit of work to put that bullshit aside on top of everything there. And
like in the beginning, I would say like, why are you so nice to me? I don't deserve this. Yeah.
And I'll be like, it's just how I am.
Yeah, so I had to learn that. So anyway, before we end, check the last comments here. I love that you can still be.
There's more to that.
Is there more to that, Mick?
Bit of a delay there.
Yeah.
But anyway.
So before we jump off, we have something really exciting to share with you guys. So for you guys who really love this and you got heaps of value from it, but at the same time you're like, man, I really want to learn more about this. I really want to grow more and dig deeper into all of this and uncover my life purpose and learn how to balance my feminine masculine energy and
Yeah.
And great balance and harmony.
Balance and harmony. And like I say, be that leader. If you are that man, you want to step into that leadership role.
And if you're a woman, learn how to come back to your feminine and heal.
Yeah.
And allow the man to take care of you. Deal with your deep issues.
Yeah, but that's yeah. what it is. Like I say, we've jam-packed so much in here. We have so much more to offer.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, too, what I think, and this is why we're excited about what we're about to say, is we know what it's benefited us with by continually doing these exercises, by continually being accountable, not only to ourselves, to other people who are doing the same thing. It's yes. It's been a big part of our journey is because we've got to this point in our life where we, when things get hard or we wanted to close up, we just go and hide from it.
Yeah.
So
what this is, I want to tell you.
I want to tell.
I'm excited.
You can. Okay.
We can share. I'll say this first time. So what this is we've decided we're launching an 8-week program. And this is going to be, 8 weeks, and this is going to be a really intimate group. So we're only opening up 10 places for this group, right? And it's only going to be by application only. Like, we want to make sure that there's the right dynamic within this group. Because the group dynamic is so powerful, you know, to have people there that are all got, you know, all about growth and learning and improving themselves, making themselves better. Beck says, I'm in. Oh, of course you are.
Awesome.
Of course you are. So this is going to be, the dates of it are, it's going to be 8 weekly trainings, right? So 8 weekly trainings within the group that everyone jumps on with a Q&A at the end to personally answer any questions that you have, where we're going to go deep and teach you like all of this stuff because there is so much that we have learned.
So much, and the touch on the personalized thing, being in a close personal group.
What's the other exciting thing?
Oh, there's so much to it. Which other parts were it? You might as well keep rolling.
What else do they get apart from the weekly trainings?
Weekly trainings, you get the choice to have calls with either myself or Tanya. Proper
or both.
Personal or both. You can make it like this. Four
one-on-one coaching calls.
Where we can go deep on anything.
So specifically just for you.
No, I don't know if we can buy you a pony. That's the randomness. Actually, how you are just now, that's perfect.
what are we doing here in this meditation here?
It's okay.
Yeah, so it's going to, 8 weekly trainings within the group, teaching you all of this stuff, going really deep on it. As well as 4 one-on-one calls. So you can choose who you want to do that with, or you could do 2 with me, 2 with C.
Or both of us if need be. That's, yeah.
Yeah, both of us. So, but the key thing is there is, you know, we can really help hone in on what it is that you need work on specifically, like within yourself. Like if it's with me, I do a lot with, you know, areas you need healing, helping you with that, learning about the energy body, all of that awesome stuff. So
I think the biggest part about this too is the accountability, which we've touched on.
Daily accountability.
If you're gonna go deep on a lot of stuff and you're gonna do a lot of healing and a lot of work, you wanna put the routines we mentioned into place plus much, much more. You wanna
morning
put them,
routine, morning, evening routine.
Routine. Constantly showing up, and that's why we want an application only too. We want to know that the group, the energy is right in the group for the accountability, because that's been a powerful thing for me. It's something that I haven't stopped at all, is the accountability.
Yeah,
like I say, when things get tough, if you are working on that tough stuff, you're accountable to the group. You want to show up.
Yeah, because if you're accountable to yourself, it's so easy to go, this morning I'm just not going to do this,
sick of crying or that. Yeah, I've done a bit of work now. I felt good for a few days. I'll show up again when I'm feeling shit again. No.
You've got to be consistent with this. It's everything.
Yeah.
Repetition.
Yeah. And I think across the whole 8 weeks, it's really designed to throw, like we've done tonight with the 3.5 hour, we're going to throw as much as we can in there because it's all about you guys and getting the best result for you guys out of this. And this will be as personalized as possible.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And of course, you know, any, like, throughout those 8 weeks, like, you have the group and you have us. Like, it's going to be super supportive. Like, so any questions that you want, throw them in the group there, and Steve and I will get back to you. And, you know, also the group will be there. The other awesome people will be in there to comment. Like, maybe they're going through the same thing. Maybe they have the same question. Maybe they can even answer it for you. Like, it's so cool. And we've been in these ourselves. We've done them before. It's really, really powerful. So, what's the investment?
I don't want to talk about this one. We butted heads about this, and I'm like, far out. Did you?
So, Steve, we talked about the value that we're going to be adding and, like, the results that people will be getting, right? Because this is, like, this is total, like, life transformation stuff. So,
it is
really, really valuable. So Steve wanted to run this for 997, but because I'm like Mother Teresa,
I'm not listening to this because
I'm like Mother Teresa. Oh. I was like, look, Steve, I want, you know, I want people who are really committed, who are really, like, ready to do this and ready to make a change in their lives. I want them to be able to do it and not have to worry about, shit, do I have the money or not? I wanted to make this a no-brainer. So we're doing this for $497, which is, like, crazy. Because
it
one,
is absolutely...
one coaching call, if you had one-on-one coaching call with me, it's $200 each. So you've already got in, yeah.
Yeah, like I say, we just go back through it's the value again. Value. The weekly trainings in itself. No, the one-on-one calls as personal. We go really, really deep. Then the accountability group. You've got the group. You've got the energy. That in itself for 8 weeks, that is next level. Yeah. That's why I said, I'm like, no, this is what I think. And because we want to make such a big contribution, we really want to make an impact. And to people who value it, well, I think it suits what you came up with. I really do. Make it as affordable as possible, because one of the areas we've got to work on, a lot of us is we stress out about financial and everything, but we want to work on all the personal stuff. So yeah,
there it is. So all you need to do, just message us if this sounds like, yes, this is something I want to be a part of. And yeah, we'll just jump on a call
and have a chat. Yeah.
Yeah. And we'll see if you're the right fit.
I think after tonight, Beck is a good fit. 9 spots left.
Count me in, guys. 9 spots left. Exactly. Yeah, guys, look, this is literally, we're not taking any more than 10 people because we don't want to take on more than 5 people each in one go, because we want to give you guys so much.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and we like to balance our lives, still have time for each other, still have time for everything else in our lives. So, if you want to get on this, get in quick, because look, there's already
one gone, and like I say, I know there's going to be more lining up. Yeah. There's a lot of people jumping on the recording of this. Yeah, they're definitely jumping on. Like, that's why I've been looking at my phone. It's like, oh, when's the recording out? When
is it
here?
Sure, 5 spots are already gone.
Yeah, they are. And like I say, we could open this up for as many people as possible. We have, like, done it at a crazy, crazy price for what we are offering.
For what we've invested
over the last 20 months. Wow. I think that's what was really, really playing on my mind when we were talking about this. But
it's all good. Of course, guys, there will be payment plans, you know, so that you can, like, whatever you're earning, you will be able to afford it.
Yeah.
Monthly payment plans. So just, again, message us if you want to chat on that. So,
cool.
Yeah, that's a wrap.
That was epic.
That was my next question. Payment plan.
Yeah, perfect.
In sync, Bex. In sync. Yeah, no, of course. Absolutely. Absolutely. Like, you know, when I first invested in my first program, mindset program, I think it was like two.
Five weeks?
Yeah, it was like $2,000.
Did you even notice I was in that?
No. And honestly, at that time, I was earning about $300 a week. And I was like, you know what, fuck it. And I went on a payment plan and I did it. And, you know, just over a year later, my whole life is completely, like, transformed. And that was just the beginning of it. But, this is going to be affordable for everyone. Because I know how it is when you're just starting off. Awesome.
All right. Thank you, everyone, so much.
Thank you for that awesome interaction. I think
thank you.
I'm happy that we got through everything. That was something that I was like looking at the end. There is a lot there, so please go back through it. Thank you for your interaction, Bex. That helps us too. And everyone jump in on the recording. Give us feedback, absolutely. What you took from it. What we can do better, that'd be really cool. If anything, I think we're pretty bloody good. You were good anyway.
You were amazing.
Oh, amazing. Oh, shit, I better up my words. You are phenomenal.
Oh, God, this is a competition.
Well, you have to win.
All right. So, thank you, guys. And, look, we would really appreciate as well. You know, you can. We'll do a post on Facebook.
Yeah.
For people who miss this and, you know, promoting the recording. Would love if you can post your... you know, your key takeaways either in the Harmonious Balance group or on the public post. Like, what were your key takeaways? What did you love about this? How has it helped you? It's always good. And then, you know, people see that. We can get more people on board. It means more happy people, more happy relationships. So, yeah,
exactly.
Thank you. Yes, you were. We had a lot of people.
We had a few at the start.
Yeah, and we had a lot of people who said they were going to be on, but
yeah,
a few people. We've got people in Canada, people in America.
Yeah, from all over. That's the cool thing about this too. Us wanting to make a big, wider impact. There's people from around the world that have messaged us about this, which has been really, really cool. And yes, Beck, if you do know people, definitely. I noticed your friend. She's going to watch the recording after.
She registered today.
Yeah, and we'll talk to you about that too. Definitely. Awesome.
That's so cool. All right. See you
cool.
guys
All right.
later.
Thank you.
We'll chat soon.
Bye-bye. Thank you very much.
Stop recording. Ooh.